is brought to you by Say Hello to Taco Bell. Now, St. Louis Cardinals baseball. A very pleasant good evening, everybody, and welcome to Shea Stadium in New York. The first of three in the Big Apple, the big series, the Cardinals and the New York Mets. And we have a threat of rain. It's a pleasant evening for baseball. Jay Randolph to call the play-by-play alongside, of course, Mike Shannon. And Mike Bush joins us a bit later on. Well, Mike, it's a World Series atmosphere here, and obviously the time has come when we're down to the nitty-gritty.
Yeah, I think you are correct, Jay. I've seen more enthusiasm over this three-game series than you would find in a playoff for sure, and maybe even a World Series. I mean, everything is keyed up here in New York. The press has really anticipated that, and of course, they relay their message to the fans, and the fans are no different. This place will be a madhouse tonight. It is jam-packed.
John Tudor steps front and center. He starts tonight for the Cardinals, the left-hander, hoping to stop the slide. The Cardinals were swept in Montreal. Incidentally, the Cubs beat Montreal 8-4 this afternoon. Now, Ron Darling will be on the hill tonight for the Mets.
Well, Ron Darling in his last 13 starts is 10-2, so he is pitching very well. So is John Tudor. The winning ball club, I believe, Jay, will have to get a good starting performance from their hurlers tonight, and I know that's what Whitey Herzog is doing in that dugout right now, is thinking that I need my left-hander John Tudor to get the job done for me.
As you probably know, Jack Clark out of the lineup this weekend with the wrist and ankle injuries. Danny Dreesen will start at first base tonight, back with the starting lineups right after this. Ready with you for game one of this series, and let's take a look at the Cardinals starting lineup. There's John Tudor, and he will have Coleman leading off. Ozzie Smith batting in the number two spot, followed by the second baseman Tom Herr. Danny Dreesen, the veteran up from Louisville, will play at first base for the injured Jack Clark. Then it's McGee and Pendleton, Morris. Steve Lake is behind the plate tonight, and the left-hander John Tudor on the hill. On the other side of the ledger, Mookie Wilson is the leadoff man for Davey Johnson's Mets. Tim Tuffle follows. Keith Hernandez, the former Redbird, bats third, then Darryl Strawberry. Kevin McReynolds, Gary Carter, Howard Johnson, Rafael Santana, and Ron Darling is on the hill. The Cardinals 3-3 here at Shea, 3-3 in St. Louis. There's Darling on the hill. We'll be back with the action right after these messages. Right, here we go. Ron Darling, a record of 12-8. In his last 75 games, he's only had 15 losses. The defense tonight: McReynolds, Wilson, and Strawberry. Johnson, Santana, Tuffle, and Hernandez. And Darling set to come in to Gary Carter. This place sold out for all three of these weekend games. A threat of showers tonight and tomorrow. Ron Darling is ready. Mike Bush has joined us. Happy to have him alongside. And Darling, born in Honolulu, Hawaii, comes home. And that's right down the middle. The umpiring crew tonight has been shaken up. We have four of the best in the business here. Terry Tate is behind the plate. John McSherry at first, Frank Pulley at second, and Bruce Fruming at third. That got away from Carter, inside and low, one ball and one strike.
Jay, you'd have to think with Jack Clark out of the lineup for this Mets series that Vince Coleman would have to be a key. If Coleman can get on base and manufacture runs, the Cards won't miss Jack Clark quite as badly.
Well, but he's always a key, as you would indicate, Mike, because of his ability to get things started. And Darling's next pitch is low, and it is... Did he call that second pitch a strike? He must have. The scoreboard says one ball and two strikes. I thought it was just the other way around. Terry Tata behind the plate, apparently calling the second pitch a strike. Oh, it is 1-2. Don't see him trying to change it for any reason. Cardinals with a record of 81-57 coming into tonight's game. That's low. Two balls and two strikes. Darling compensated for a poor National League Championship Series start with a 1-1 record and a 1.53 ERA in the World Series last year. Originally the Rangers' number one pick. That's just outside, and the count is full. Coleman has hit at a 256 clip this season against the Mets. The payoff pitch is low, and Coleman reaches.
Well, that's exactly the way the Cardinals want to get started. Vince Coleman reaching base against Ron Darling, and a 1-2 count on him, and then lost him. So Coleman trying to get things started at first base, and here comes Ozzie.
The Cardinals 6-6 against the Mets this season, 3-3 here and 3-3 in St. Louis. The Redbirds have lost their last three, as you probably know. They have won only four of their last 10. Smith right at the 300 mark, having a remarkably fine season, 70 RBIs, and Darling throws over. The Redbirds still leading the National League in batting. 271 is the average. The Mets have a 270 average. Darling again comes over, and an excellent stop by Hernandez.
Darling has one of the best pickoff moves in the league. He's good at holding runners on base, and even though this game might take a long time if the Cardinals can get some base runners, Darling won't worry about that. He'll just keep his eyes on Coleman and Smith in the top of the Cardinals lineup and try to hold them on.
For those of you just joining us, again, it was Chicago over Montreal 8-4 this afternoon. So the Cardinals start tonight a game and a half ahead of the Mets. Look out, back in time is Coleman. A game and a half up on the Mets and 2.5 up on Montreal. The Cardinals 52-36 against right-handers. Vince bluffed to go, didn't go, and the pitch is high to Ozzie. Smith did some fine hitting in Montreal. It went by the boards as the Birds were swept by the Expos. And popped up, and Johnson couldn't get to it. Ozzie trying to get it down the left side, popping it up, and a big hand from this sellout crowd for Howard Johnson.
Well, that'll give you an idea of what kind of crowd we have here tonight. Howard Johnson with the 100% effort right there, and he gets a standing ovation even though he didn't make the grab.
Smith looking down to Nick Leyva coaching at third base. Coleman at first, one ball and one strike. Coleman not going up the middle, and ricocheted over to Santana, and they double up Coleman. A hard hit ball off Darling, ricocheting right to Santana, who doubled up Coleman.
Ozzie hit it right on the nose, as you can see, but it goes right off Ron Darling's, the heel of his glove, and there was Rafael Santana. Nothing Coleman could do. He was halfway between first and second, and he has doubled off of first. Not a good way to start this three-game series. You call that a little bad luck right there.
Alan, the Cardinals had a similar situation in the first inning at Montreal when Brooks took a liner out of the air and stopped the rally. And now Darling taking this shot up the middle that, if it doesn't hit him, definitely goes through. He says he's all right. Davey Johnson out talking with him along with a Mets trainer, but the play went Darling off to the shortstop Santana. Now watch it here. It's hit right on the nose. It ricochets off the glove. If that ball gets by, it's right up the middle.
Yeah, that's a base hit.
The play went 1-6-4 on the double play.
Now, it did not hurt Darling's throwing hand. It was his glove hand and off the heel of the hand, and that can smart, especially when the ball was hit as hard as it was. But Darling appears to be all right, and now with two outs, Tommy Herr will take his place at the dish.
And Herr has been mired in a slump, although he's hit very well against these Mets this year. Tommy's average is down to 269. He hit the ball hard a couple of times in Montreal, but didn't get a break. 324 this season against the Mets. Darling's first pitch is high. San Francisco is underway at Cincinnati in the first inning. The Giants on top 1-0. New York is playing at Toronto. They're just underway. Action in the American League, and folks around here interested in that, of course. That caught the outside corner. New York did not score in the first at Exhibition Stadium in Toronto. One ball and one strike to her. Outside, two balls and one strike.
That San Francisco-Cincinnati series in the National League West, another big series for that division, because Cincinnati comes into tonight's action trailing the Giants by 5 games, and now they've got 3 at Riverfront. They could get within 2 games with a sweep.
And it is 3 balls and 1 strike to her. Oh, that shot by Ozzie was destined, it looked like, to get through, and Darling was able to get the glove on it, ricocheted right to Santana. That's the way things have been going for the Redbirds of late. Ozzie lining it up there. Now here is her with this fly ball in the left. So the walk to Coleman and the shot for the double play by Smith, and then the fly ball by her. And after a half inning of play, no score.
McGee in center and John Morris in right field tonight. Pendleton, Smith, her, and Dan Dreesen, the infield third to first. In the battery, John Tudor, the Cardinals ace on the mound, and Steve Lake. Tudor comes in with a record of 6-2 and a 3.99 earned run average. It was just about 2 years ago tonight when the Cardinals and the Mets met in a key series back in 1985, John Tudor against Dwight Gooden. Jay, you'll remember that game. Tudor out-dueled Gooden for 10 innings, Cardinals winning that one 1-0. Hopefully more of the same kind of performance from John tonight.
Tudor's first pitch to Mookie Wilson is outside. Mookie batting 302. 33 runs batted in, 8 home runs. This one is in there for a strike. Tudor pitching in his home state. He's from upstate New York, Schenectady. He's been one of the best left-handers in the majors since joining the Cardinals, but he has had his share of injuries, more than his share, you might say. That's strike two, and Wilson looks back at Terry Tata, who's calling the balls and strikes tonight. The Mets have 23 games remaining, 10 of them at home and 13 on the road. They have a team batting average of 270. They've set a club record of home runs with 169 coming into tonight's game. He strikes him out. Oh, Wilson is the first victim for Tudor.
What Tudor does so well is he changes speeds. He keeps the hitters off balance, and this is a perfect example right here. Look at a nice grooving pitch right down the middle, and Mookie just watched it. Another good look at it, and Mookie knew it. One gone.
And Tim Tuffle standing in, playing at second base tonight, hitting 314. 44 runs batted in, 10 home runs. A little low. Tudor coming back from the broken foot problem. That caught the outside corner. Minnesota scores at Cleveland in the first. They lead 1-0. Pittsburgh at Philadelphia just underway down at Veterans Stadium. And Ozzie can't handle this one as it's over his head into center. Tuffle has a little looper, a one-out single.
Well, this guy has done it all year for the Mets against left-handed pitchers, hitting 314 coming into this game. He is not that kind of hitter, but Davey Johnson's platoon system has really worked well for the Mets. They have Wally Backman hitting against right-handers and Tim Tuffle hitting against left-handers, and Tuffle the first hit of the ball game.
The former Redbird first baseman Keith Hernandez standing in. Hernandez hitting 303, 75 runs batted in, 16 home runs.
J, Jay, listening to the Mets radio broadcast on the way in from the airport tonight, they had Keith Hernandez as a guest, and he's calling this game tonight, the most crucial game of this series, because if the Cardinals, who lost three in Montreal, if they can win this one, that will give them the onus and perhaps the momentum to maybe get another one and leave New York with two or three wins.
Well, this is the big game. Tudor called on to stop the slide here tonight. One ball and no strikes to Hernandez, who has hit 320 against his former mates this season. Strawberry's on deck. Tuffle is at first base. Inside. Well, don't forget, later in this game, we'll select the Meineke Discount Mufflers MVP, the award, a donation of $50 to the St. Louis Variety Club in the name of tonight's most outstanding player. Two balls and no strikes. Hernando steps away as one of the big jets coming out of LaGuardia is right overhead. The wind is right tonight for the flight pattern to be right over this big stadium. Jammed to the rafters here in Queens, New York tonight. Strike on the inside corner, 2-1. Hernandez, now 33 years old, the peerless first baseman. There are none better playing that position when you combine all his talents.
Tries to run this down, but it skips right on by him. It goes to the wall. Tim Tuffle was off and running with the pitch. He rounds third. He'd score easily. And Hernandez is in with a double. And the Mets lead it 1-0 here in the first with only one out. And here comes Darryl Strawberry.
RBI number 76 on the year for Hernandez. Strawberry hitting 376. That's in there. Strawberry looks back at Tata. Mets doing a little complaining early about some of the called strikes. Fastball is outside. One ball and one strike. Strawberry has hit 308 against the Cardinals this year. 276, as you see on the year.
Wednesday night against Philadelphia, Darryl hit two out here at Shea Stadium.
The Mets have hit 15 home runs in their last 10 games.
They are breathing down the Cardinals' necks, and they have an early lead here at Shea, 1-0. Now, this is a good move on the part of Steve Lake. Tudor seems annoyed with himself for giving up that double, and of course the crowd can get to him, and now they're just talking it over. And of course you got to keep your eye out for Keith Hernandez at second base. He's a very smart ball player, and he could be picking up some of Steve Lake's signals, and they'll probably change the rotation of those signals.
Strawberry, the number one pick in the nation for the Mets in 1980. One ball and one strike. Here's a long one in the right. Way back.
Gets it up, right in his wheelhouse, and I'm telling you, this was a towering fly ball. No doubt about it. Two home runs on Wednesday. He's hit another home run tonight. And before we can even blink here at Shea Stadium, it's 3-0 New York.
Kevin McReynolds batting 283. And they're celebrating early here. Three runs on three hits. And the Mets have popped out on the lead. One ball and one strike to Kevin McReynolds. McReynolds is very, very well against the Cardinals. 326 on the season. 283 overall. Outside, two balls and one strike. McReynolds. The Padres parted with this talented player. Cost the Mets a blue chip outfield prospect.
Oh, brother.
In the left. That's four hits in a row for the Mets.
Well, that one was hit hard, too. Hernandez, Strawberry, and McReynolds have all hit the ball hard. He just golfed at that one and hit it over the head of Terry Pendleton, a base hit. Still only one out, and here comes Gary Carter. This Mets lineup is relentless. That's why they are the reigning world champions. Ozzie Smith, the wizard, coming in to talk to John, trying to settle him down.
Carter has hit 255 this season against the Cardinals and 239 overall. He's tailed off a bit, but he still has 73 runs batted in, 18 home runs. Pitches outside for a ball. Cincinnati got two in the bottom of the first. They lead the San Francisco Giants 2-1, and they're still batting at Cincinnati. LA got a run in the first at Atlanta. Throw over by Tudor. Gary Carter is going to be a quarterback at UCLA when he was drafted by the Expos in the third round in 82, and he opted for baseball. He came here with the Mets in 84. For Brooks and Yeomans and Fitzgerald and Herm Winningham in that big deal. Just a little low, two balls and no strikes.
For individual stats, this has not been a good year for Gary Carter, hitting just 239. But one thing about Gary, they moved him from the number four spot in the batting order to the number six spot. Still, even though he's hitting only 239, he's got 18 homers and 73 RBI, still very respectable numbers.
Ball three. And with three runs home and one out and a runner at first, Carter's got the green light if he wants to go. Took it 3-1.
Of course, the key to John Tudor's game is control. He's had a little problem here getting ahead of the hitters in the first inning. Started off just fine, striking out Mookie Wilson.
Runner going, pitch is low. First walk given up. Two on and one out. Here comes Mike Rourke, the Cardinal pitching coach, out to talk things over with Tudor.
Tudor started off this inning by striking out Mookie Wilson. Then Tim Tuffle hit a little soft base hit to center, and that got the Mets started. Hernandez followed with a run scoring double, made it 1-0. Then Darryl Strawberry with a towering home run, that made it 3-0. Kevin McReynolds then followed with a base hit, and now Gary Carter has walked.
Scott Terry is heating up for the Cardinals in the bullpen. Let's pause for station identification on the Cardinals Television Network. KSDK, Channel 5 in St. Louis.
5 Schnooks. The French tutor finds himself down 3-0. Whitey Herzog on the right, Mike Rook on the left. 2 on and 1 out. And Howard Johnson, who's been a Cardinal killer all season long, stands in. He's batting 278 on the year, but 381 against the Redbirds this season. First pitch to Johnson is outside. There are Johnson's figures. 34 home runs for Howard Johnson.
And they've 90 RBIs. That's the most on the team.
Yeah, they've been spending a lot of time looking at his bats this year, but he's been doing the job. Quite a competitor. Good stop by Lake. 2 balls and no strikes.
The Mets, of course, platooned Ray Knight and Howard Johnson a year ago and really gave Ray Knight most of the playing time, particularly in postseason play. And a lot of people felt that Knight was the heart of this ball club, and when they lost him, they would lose a lot, but not with these numbers by Howard Johnson. And he's not hitting too badly with runners in scoring position, as you can see.
Hojo is a stockbroker in the offseason. It's been a bull market lately, and he has been a bull when it's come to hitting the baseball this season.
So he's making all kinds of money, isn't
he?
Well,
I don't know. He's doing very well. The 2-0. Oh, the changeup got him. He was way out in front of that one. Toronto gets 2 runs, and the Blue Jays lead the Yankees 2-0. New York batting in the second inning. It is 3-0 Mets, and they're still batting here in the first. Two balls and one strike to Howard Johnson. They call him Hojo. Time call. He steps out.
Kevin McReynolds, the base runner at second. Gary Carter at first. Mets already lead it 3-0. We're only in the first with one out. Howard Johnson at the plate.
Tudor taking a lot of time. Is set now. Outside, 3-1.
Well, again, we talked about it. John Tudor, in order to be effective, has got to get the ball over the plate. He's got to nibble at those corners. He's got to change speeds. And he is just very frustrated with himself right now. 3 balls and 1 strike.
Johnson has made a tremendous impact with the Mets for many reasons, but one of which is that they finally found a fellow to play third base. He's the 78th third baseman in the history of the Mets franchise. And a bluff back at second. And Lake wants to talk things over again. Wilson struck out. Tuffle single. Keith Hernandez doubled home Tuffle. Strawberry hit the 2-run homer. McReynolds single. Carter has walked. 3 balls and 1 strike to Howard Johnson. The Mets have won 8 of their last 10. They are 28-19 against left-handers and 43-28 here at home. New York starting the night just a game and a half back of the Cardinals. The National League East race, a dandy. Again, Montreal lost today to Chicago 8-4. Pendleton goes to the bag, throws across, double play. So Johnson hits into the double play, but the Mets get 3. After 1, New York has the lead. At 1 Central Time, NBC will be carrying the Cardinals and the Mets game of the week, and then on Sunday we'll be back here 12:30 to finish off this Cardinal-Mets series. Monday we're off to Philadelphia for a 2-game set, and then Wednesday the Cardinals and the Pirates, as well as Thursday at 6:30. So lots of action for you
along the Cardinals television network. Later in this game, we'll have the Edward D. Jones and Company scoreboard updating the scores. Visit the Edward D. Jones and Company office nearest you for your free personal financial organizer. Whitey Herzog, the White Rat, looks on as Dreesen leads it off in the second inning. Ball one to Dreesen. Dreesen up from Louisville. Long time with the Cincinnati Reds. Also played for Montreal. He's been around. And this one is a foul ball. Just foul down the right side. Dreesen in the lineup with Jack Clark out. And the prognosis on Clark, as you have probably heard, is that he will be out a week to 10 days. He's optimistic, Clark is, that he'll be back before that. And he's taking treatment. He is here with the ball club. Gene Gieselman working on him. And we'll have to wait and see. The 1-1 pitch, strike two.
And Jay, of course, one of the reasons that Whitey wants Dan Dreesen in the lineup to replace Jack Clark is because he's been in these pressure situations before. Dan, of course, a member of the Big Red Machine, the Cincinnati Reds dynasty of sorts, a mini dynasty in the 70s.
Two balls and two strikes to Dreesen. Way high, 3-2. Darling walked Coleman to start the game. Now he walks Dreesen. So the Redbirds have had the leadoff men here in the first two innings on board.
Coming around for the play, center fielder, number 51,
Willie McGee. McGee has hit .250 this season against the Mets, and overall, Willie's average at .290. Big year in the RBI department for him, 96. He had gone kind of unnoticed for a while, I think, because of the great season that Clark and Smith were having. That's a little high, and Darling's having a control problem at the moment. Third in the National League in hits is McGee with 158. The batting champion and the MVP in 85. Slumped very badly in 86, but has come back fine this year after the problems with the knee. Ball two. Cardinals 23-13 on grass this year, 35-31 against the East, and 50-43 playing night baseball. And ball three. And Darling has hit a tough streak here.
Now here's another guy who relies on his control. He can find the corners just like John Tudor can, and if he gets into trouble, that could be good news for the baseball Cardinals. Dan Dreesen already on first base.
And a walk to McGee. Two on and none out for Pendleton. Darling had an outstanding career at Yale University. Had a couple of years of football up there as a defensive back as well as a baseball player. And his feuds with manager Davey Johnson are legendary here. They sometimes differ on strategy, philosophy. I guess when you graduate or went to Yale, you talk philosophy with about anybody you want to. Two on and none out. Pendleton batting .299. Pops it up foul.
Now you saw Terry just go up there swinging. Darling was having trouble getting the ball over the plate, so Terry thought he's just going to try to blow one right by me, right down the middle, and that's exactly what Darling tried to do, but Terry fouled it off.
Minnesota gets a run in the first. Cleveland gets a run in the first. They're in the second, 1-1. Swing and a miss. And Carter, is he all right? Looks up at Tata.
Pretty good pitch by Ron Darling.
Did the bat hit him when it came around? Yeah, hit him on the top of the head. I thought it did. Carter was looking up. Here's another angle of it, and boom.
Well, it was a nice follow-through by Terry.
No balls and two strikes. Darling could use the strikeout, two on and none out. to the right side, and a good job by Pendleton as he moves the runners along. 3-0 goes over to third. McGee is at second for Morris.
Now this is what a good hitter will do. He will sacrifice himself to move those runners, to advance them to second and third, and Terry hits it, pulls the ball to Keith Hernandez. He really does not have a play at second base, so he goes to first for the easy out, and now the Cardinals have two runs in scoring position, and here comes John Morris, who is in the lineup because he hits so well here at Shea Stadium.
333 against New York this year. 277 on the season. Morris with 16 RBIs, three home runs. That's low. Pittsburgh and Philadelphia in the third inning, no score. Cincinnati leads the Giants 2-1 in the second inning. LA 2-0 over Atlanta's second inning. Strike on the corner.
Cardinals.
Mike, I was going to mention Detroit plays at Milwaukee a bit later on, Kansas City at Oakland. Toronto's leading New York in the second, 2-0. And Minnesota and Cleveland now are 1-1 in the second. To the right side, and a run is going to score as Hernandez beats Morris to the bag, and Dreesen comes home. So the Cardinals get on the board. It's 3-1. RBI number 17 for Morris. On the shot down the right side.
This is a good play by Keith Hernandez. You see, he does not try to backhand it. He goes over, gets his body in front of it, makes sure of the one out. That keeps Willie McGee at third base. The Cardinals get one across, though. It's now 3-1, and the Cardinals still don't have a base hit.
Steve Lake. Lake hitting 353 against the Mets this year, 267 on the year. He set a lot of personal highs, of course, 19 runs batted in, a couple of home runs. Played a lot early on when Pena was down. Pena, incidentally, has signed a extension on his contract, a new 2-year deal. And this gets, no, it doesn't. What a play by Santana. He's out. Oh, what a play by Santana. I thought the ball was going to get through the hole. Santana comes up with it. And the throw in the dirt, but Hernandez digs it out.
Now, the amazing thing about this play, Santana does a great job of getting to the ball, but how does he set up and throw out Steve Lake? Not one of the fastest players on the Cardinals, but that is a pretty good throw. Just a one bouncer to Keith Hernandez. They had him by a step, and the Cardinals are out of the inning.
After 1.5, 3-1, New York.
Copyrighted telecast is authorized under television rights granted by the St. Louis National Baseball Club Incorporated solely for the entertainment of our audience, and any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the St. Louis Cardinals and Major League Baseball is prohibited.
And the first pitch to Santana outside for a ball, as so often happens, a man who makes a great play leads off the inning, Santana. That was some play made deep in the hole against Lake. One ball and one strike. Santana, the former Cardinal, 29 years old from La Romana in the Dominican Republic. This fellow was signed as a free agent in January of 84, traded out to the Cardinals for George Frazier. In February, Cards released him, and then he was picked up by this New York club, originally signed by the Yankees, Santana. Two balls and two strikes.
And like so many of these Mets, he is hot right now, has a 6-game hitting streak. His longest hitting streak of the season was 7 games, so he is at his best right now.
Down the line, foul. The Mets have a rather unenviable statistic, yet, of course, they're right in the thick of the race. Coming into tonight's game, they had left on base 1,043 players. That leads the major leagues in men who have been left on.
I'll bet you most of them were in the first half of the season.
That's right. A little check swing, and Tudor throws him out. Ron Darling is next, as we'll watch Santana. He had second thoughts, but a little check swing shot out in front.
Well, this is the second straight inning that John Tudor has gotten the leadoff man with a pretty easy out. Unfortunately, last inning, after he struck out Mookie Wilson, the Mets proceeded to get four straight hits and three runs.
Darling pops it up, and it's her calling for it in fair territory. Two gone. And we're back around to the top of the order, and Mookie Wilson.
Number one, Mookie Wilson.
In the third inning in Cincinnati, Jay, the Reds are desperately trying to get back in the National League West race, and they've got San Francisco in town. The Reds have a 4-1 lead with the Giants batting in the top of the third.
Funny how you get these situations. It's a crucial series for the Reds this weekend. And here in New York, the big battle in the East. Outside for ball one to Mookie Wilson.
It's that time of the year.
Mookie, after striking out, now batting 300 against the Cards on the year. That's inside, two balls and no strikes. The Mets won their last two. Swing and a miss tomorrow afternoon. Greg Matthews against Dwight Gooden. That game will come your way with Ben Scully and Joe Garagiola. We'll be back on Sunday when Danny Cox goes against David Cohn. Into left field. Coleman going back, and it is out of here.
Been the most frustrating moment for John Tudor this game. Even though the Mets have four runs now, Tudor had Wilson off balance the first time he had him off balance this time, but then he served one up and Mookie hit it out.
Tim Tuffel has reached base safely in 60 of the 77 games that he has played for the Mets this year. The Mets now have hit 171 home runs on the season. Swing and a miss. Tuffel singled and scored the first run of this game. The Mets have four runs on five hits. Two balls and one strike.
You almost had that one, Jay.
I learned a long time ago, don't try to catch those. That one was off to the right side of us, thank goodness.
Just duck and get out of the way, right?
That's the best advice I can give you, Mike. Inside, ball three, 3-2. Yeah, if you need a baseball, I get you one. Don't hurt your hand trying to catch one of those, will you? Here's the payoff pitch and a walk. Here's Hernandez. He doubled home Tuffel in the first inning and later scored on the strawberry home run.
Well, that was a key batter to lose because you don't want to walk Tim Tuffel when you've got the meat of this Mets order coming up. Hernandez, then Strawberry, McReynolds, etc., etc., etc.
The Mets, the defending world champions. Just outside.
Last inning, we showed you Scott Terry warming up in the Cardinal bullpen. He has since sat down. There is nobody warming up at the moment.
Inside, two balls and no strikes. Tudor steps off. There's manager Whitey Herzog. Nick Leyva, the third base coach, fine baseball man on his left there, and pitching coach Mike Rourke to the right.
That C on Keith Hernandez's jersey, of course, stands for captain. He's the captain of this Mets ball club.
Took a page out of the hockey book, I guess, right, for that. Two balls and one strike.
I think he's the only player in the major leagues to wear AC. A lot of captains on ball clubs, but I think he's the only guy to advertise it.
Oh, and he took a lot off of that one and got Hernandez.
Maybe John's best pitch of the night. Needed that one, or he would have gone 3-1 on Hernandez.
Now it is 2-2, two out, the runner at first.
Good
pitch. And he strikes him out. They pick up the run on the homer by Mookie Wilson. After two, Mets lead 4-1. Into the Spuds McKenzie Mug Night Tuesday the 22nd. Phillies will be in town, 7:35 game. First 35,000 fans, 21 and over with a paid admission, receive that Spuds McKenzie Cardinal beer mug. Remember that date now, the 22nd, sponsored by Bud Light, Spuds McKenzie Mug Night at Busch Stadium. We move into the third inning, 4-1 Mets. Here to call the play is Mike Busch.
Cardinals, one run, no hits, no errors. The Mets 4-5-0. This is John Tudor. Count 0-1 to him. Cardinals have gotten their leadoff man on in both the first and the second inning. They got one across in the second without a hit. It's now 0-2 to John Tudor.
Some of the fans might remember back on April 17th, the Cardinals won here 4-3, and it was a single by Tudor, throwing error by Santana, and a two-out, two-run single by Herr that erased the 3-2 Met lead, and the Redbirds won that first game between these two clubs here.
Good pitch by Ron Darling, and that's one out for the Cardinals here in the third. And here comes Vince Coleman. Cardinals need him to get on base. Without Jack Clark in the lineup, and in case you just joined us, Jack Clark will miss all three games of this Mets series with a sprained wrist and a sprained ankle. Cardinals playing Dan Dreesen, the veteran, at first base tonight. Cardinals need to manufacture some runs. They did it in the second, but they're trailing by three, 4-1 here in the third. Vince Coleman walked in the first inning, and then with Ozzie Smith at bat, he drilled one. It looked like it was going to be in center field for a base hit. However, it went off the heel of Ron Darling's glove right into the hands of Rafael Santana. That was one out, and then they doubled Vince off of first. 1-0 pitch, 1-1.
Coleman, the Florida A&M graduate, matured a great deal this season. He's been much, much more patient at the plate. And he has really put together an outstanding year.
Darling has walked three, struck out one. 1-1 pitch, called strike, 1-2. Terry Tata, the umpire behind home plate. Vince Coleman not real happy about that call.
New York and Toronto. The Blue Jays leading it 2-0, third inning at Toronto. There's Terry Tata. It's a good crew here. They shuffle up the crews for this series, and Tata, McSherry, Pulley, and Frumming are here.
Vince with one down the line and left, foul by about 5 feet. Good idea. Went with the pitch and tried to slice it down the left field line. Count remains 1-2. Mets scoring 3 in the first, 1 in the second. Two home runs so far for New York. Darryl Strawberry with a two-run shot in the first, and then Mookie Wilson with a solo shot in the second. Cardinals getting their run on a fielder's choice in the second inning. One ball and two strikes to Vince. One out. We're in the third. Here's Darling's pitch. Check swing foul again. The opposite way, and it's still one and two. Cincinnati now at bat in the third inning at Riverfront, leading San Francisco 4-1. Chicago beat Montreal this afternoon at Wrigley 8-4. So the Expos 2.5 games behind as we play here tonight at Shea. 1-2 pitch on the way. Checked his swing. Not in time. Strike three, and there are two outs for the Cardinals, and here comes Ozzie.
Well, Vince was tied in a knot. Darling's pitch down. The bottom dropped right out of it, but he went around.
Yeah, Vince was hitting a nine iron shot right there. So two outs, and here comes Ozzie. We mentioned that he hit the ball right on the nose the last time up. It all went for naught when Ron Darling, like a hockey goalie, acted quickly and just blocked the ball from going into center field. Turned into a double play.
Ricocheted right to Santana. He doubled up Coleman. Ozzie with a career high 70 runs batted in coming into tonight's game.
0-1 to the Wizard of Oz. Next pitch inside. 1-1, two outs. Cardinals trailing 4-1 in the third inning here at Shea. Big crowd on hand. Darling working quickly, and there's another strike, 1-2.
This is the toughest ticket in New York in a long, long time, I'll tell you. I got out of my hotel room early this morning. The phones are ringing off the wall. People want tickets, and people want to wish the Cardinals the best.
1-2 pitch on the way. Swing and foul to the left side. Still 1-2. Darling working in a hurry. He struck out Tudor, struck out Coleman, and this is Ozzie Smith with a count of one ball and two strikes. Pittsburgh in the fourth, leading Philadelphia 1-0. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball, misses outside. 2-2. Waiting in the wings, Tommy Herr. Jets fly over Shea Stadium. The wind is blowing in from center field, the outfield playing straight away and pretty deep. Tap foul along the left side. Two balls and two strikes. They play Ozzie straight away. It's a pretty good wind out there. But obviously, it's not preventing the Mets from hitting home runs. Strawberry with one, Mookie Wilson with one. Two balls, two strikes to the Wizard of Oz. Here's the 2-2 offering. Struck him out. Darling strikes out the side. For the Cardinals, no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left. After 2.5 here at Shea, the Mets leading it 4-1.
Dick Ford and Deanne Lane have a recap of the day's news and the Eyewitness News update. Buell Perkins will have a report on the Pope's activities in Miami, Florida, and Columbia, South Carolina. Meteorologist Bob Richards, a look at the weekend cool down, along with, of course, all the sports highlights from Art Holliday. That's tonight on the Eyewitness News update.
The third inning.
We go to the last of the third. It'll be Darryl Strawberry, Kevin McReynolds, and Gary Carter up for the Mets. Last time up, Strawberry hit one out. A towering drive to right field. A two-run shot. He was swinging on the first pitch right there. Tudor pulled the string. It's 0-1.
Strawberry now with four home runs and eight runs batted in his last six games.
One ball and one strike to Darryl Strawberry, who has come alive here in September.
He's had some personal problems. He and his wife back together now and everything in good shape. He says he Feels like a new man. He looked like a new man bombing that one out of here in the first inning. Strawberry is such a talented athlete. He really is an amazing ball player, and he's got an opportunity, of course, to be one of the very, very great ones.
1-2 pitch. Struck him out. Good pitch by John Tudor.
That was.
Tudor mixed it up. That's the best job he's done on a hitter all night. He really mixed it up on Darryl Strawberry. Look at him come low and outside, nibbling the corners, and that's the John Tudor that can be victorious. He's got to be able to find the corners, find the black part of the plate, and he did it right there, and there's one gone for the Mets here in the third. That's two strikeouts in a row by John Tudor, who seems to be settling down now. 1-0 to Kevin McReynolds.
He's a young man who a lot of the folks in our viewing area remember was a star for the Razorbacks, University of Arkansas.
1-1 to Kevin McReynolds, and what a job he's done in left field for the Mets this year. Came into the game 25 home runs, 81 RBIs, hitting .283, and he just goes about his job quietly and gets it done. 2-1. Single the last time up. Was left stranded at second base. Mets getting four hits in the first inning and three runs. One hit in the second. Not a Mookie Wilson home run. It's 4-1 New York. John with a few problems off the rubber, but count remains 2-1, 1-1. One out. We're in the third. Here's the pitch. A long fly ball to left. Coleman and McGee over. McGee calling for it near the warning track. He makes the catch. McReynolds got under it a little bit too much. Fortunately for John Tudor, and there are two gone.
Now batting, catcher Gary Carter.
And that'll bring up the catcher Gary Carter, who walked the last time up. There's a look at the arithmetic. Gary Carter versus the Cards this season is averaged better against the Cardinals than it is against the rest of the league. Just .239 coming into this game, but hitting .255 against the Redbirds. On deck, Howard Johnson.
Carter has 6 homers and 25 runs batted in his last 38 games. He's cranked it up a little bit. You knew he would.
Another good pitch by John Tudor. 1-1. Two outs in the third inning. Mets lead at 4-1. Pittsburgh now leading Philadelphia 2-0 in the fifth inning at Veterans Stadium, Philadelphia. Another good pitch by Tudor, 1-2. In Cincinnati, 4-1 Reds in the third over the Giants. Down in Atlanta, the Dodgers leading the Braves 2-0 in the third. One-two effort. Fouled off the glove of Steve Lake. Stays 1-2. In the American League, Toronto 2-0 over the Yankees in the fourth. Baltimore out in front of Boston 3-2 in the fourth. In Cleveland, the Twins and the Indians are tied 1-1. And it's 1-2 to Gary Carter. Wind up and the pitch by Tudor. Right back up the middle. Tommy Herr played him perfectly. And down goes Gary Carter. A 1-2-3 inning for John Tudor, his best of the game. And we play three here at Shea Stadium with the Mets out in front, 4-1.
A reminder that every time the Cardinals hit a home run, the quality builders at Taylor Morley Simon will make a donation to the Special Olympics. Taylor Morley Simon invites you to visit Polo Run near Creve Coeur, three unique communities in one. Well, we move into the fourth inning, 4-1. Mets have the lead. Tommy Herr leading it off, and here's old Irish Mike Shannon.
Thank you, Jennings. You've already spotted this New York club 3 runs.
It's been tough going here.
That's not a good idea. Tommy Herr looks at the first one outside, a fastball from Darling. Although Darling has allowed no hits, only 1 run, he has not been that sharp. Here's a ground ball to Keith Hernandez. He races to his right, as you see, and takes it unassisted. Cardinals scored their only run with the benefit of 2 walks and 2 ground outs in the second inning. You know, that was a bad omen in the first inning,
Jay.
Once again, that line drive off the bat of Ozzie Smith, the same thing.
Monday
night. Of Montreal.
I mentioned it too, Mike. It's the way I just looked back and I said, uh-oh, what a way to begin a series. And here we've had it happen to us twice on this road trip.
Dan Dreesen is taking over the first base duties with Jack Clark out with that sprained ankle and sprained wrist. Dreesen walked and scored the only Cardinal run of this game. That was in the second. This fella's been around.
Cincinnati, Montreal, San Francisco, Houston, and now St. Louis.
14 big league career. He really belts one. Strawberry, what a play. Everything going the wrong way as far as the Cardinals are concerned. They hit a line drive. Somebody is standing underneath it.
They hit a line drive. Tailing away from Strawberry, but he covers the ground and makes it out there.
Looked like a sure hit when it left the bat.
It sure did. Ed Conley from Afton, Missouri is here rooting on the Cardinals. Also Cindy Stern and Gloria Ellis here from St. Louis to root on the Redbirds.
That's eight in a row now retired by Darling since that pair of walks he gave up in the second inning. He walked Dreesen and then he walked Willie McGee. And since then he's retired eight in succession. Willie McGee had a good series in Montreal, even though the Cardinals lost all three. And, of course, that winning streak that Montreal had put together came to an end today at Wrigley Field. Giants are trying to climb back in the race. They're beating the Cincinnati club is beating San Francisco 4-1 as the Reds try to get back into the race.
I mentioned earlier this is a crucial series for the Reds this weekend over there. Mike, I think they really need a sweep to get back in it. I think that's what it would take for them.
Well, that would certainly help. That's what New York's thinking about up here is a sweep. They can win this one tonight with Darling. Then they have Dwight Gooden going tomorrow. And both Gooden and Darling have been going very well of late. Darling has been outstanding, hasn't he? 13 starts. He's 10-2 in those 13. His last 13 to the mound. Willie hangs on as he fouls off that 2-2.
That statistic I gave earlier about Darling is really amazing when you stop to think about it. He's only had 15 losses in his last 75 starts.
That's what you call consistent hurling from your starter. And he's tough here again tonight. No hits. He has not allowed one until Willie tries. But there's McDermott. And that's nine in a row retired by the New York pitcher. Three up, three down as we go to the fourth. The latter three with the Mets leading 4-1. 4-1 as New York leads. They bat here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Howard Johnson is the number seven hitter in their lineup. And when you have a man that has 34 home runs, 90 RBIs, batting seventh, I'd say you had a pretty good lineup. How about you, Jim?
Formidable. Formidable.
And you see the figures, Howard Johnson against the Cardinals this year. He's been a big plus for New York against St. Louis. Changeup gets him out in front. And even now at 1-1. Howard Johnson is only one home run shy of the National League record for home runs by a switch hitter. That record is held by Rip Collins. The St. Louis Cardinal player did that back in 1934. Well, Johnson's having a career year to say the least. First time up, he hit into an inning double play in the first after the Mets had scored three times. And they lead 4-1 here in the fourth. Half swing, he holds up in time as John McSherry. He was asked about the swing. He said no, he did not go around. Tudor with a rocky start, trying to get it back in tow. Big crowd sold out here at Shea Stadium. In fact, they're sold out for all three games here. And they came early tonight, didn't they, Jay?
Oh, boy.
They were here and
rocking and rolling
in
2 hours
seats
before
right.
Game time.
All week long, the Mets I've been urging, and you see how Johnson went another base hit. He got a high delivery, and he really ripped it into left field. They've been urging the folks coming to the game this weekend by radio, television, to take the train and not drive. Here's that high fastball, and Johnson really drills it into left field. Tell you, the balls that have been hit against Tudor tonight have not been cheap ones. Here's a fellow that's having his best season ever, Rafael Santana. Johnson, with the 34 home runs, 90 RBIs, has also stolen 29 bases. So he has been a big threat, not only at the plate, but also on the bases. I'll tell you how keyed up this crowd was at the beginning. You couldn't even hear the airplanes when they were up and screaming.
That's right.
Now, I've never seen a night here that you couldn't see the airplanes,
or hear them
rather. We're riding the old flight path tonight. And Tudor's been in the flight path of the New York Bats. Another stolen base, number 30 for Howard Johnson. And he joins a rather exclusive club. 30 home runs and 30 stolen bases. There haven't been many in the names that are on that list.
The 30-30 club, here it is. And they're standing all over this ballpark and applauding the season that Johnson has had. Oh, look at these fans. On their feet everywhere.
He joins names like Bobby Bonds, Willie Mays, Hank Aaron, Ken Williams, Tommy Harper, Dale Murphy, and Eric Davis. All those men have hit 30 home runs and stolen 30 bases, and Howard Johnson joins a very exclusive group. One and one now on Rafael Santana.
Mike got a nice note from A.J.S. Hopkins up in Alton, Illinois, inviting you and I to come up there and play golf with him. I hope we're not able to go until late October.
That's when the World Series will go, to late October. Mets scored in the first and the second. They're trying to do it again here in the fourth. They play Santana to hit into right field. He has a six-game hitting streak. Good play by Blake as he blocks that delivery. New York has come roaring into this series, and they stayed red hot when they scored three times in the first inning. The Mets have won 8 of their last 10, 12 out of 16, 27 of their last 41, and they've won 36 of their last 55. And they've climbed right back into the race. They're trying to win tonight and come within a half a game of first place. And if they do that, they'll have Dwight Gooden on the hill tomorrow. It's a day game. That'll go into the seats and put the count at 2-2. Not only are they sold out here tonight, but they're also sold out tomorrow and Sunday.
And I mean sold out.
Jay has a lot of tickets, so I'm going to call him at the hotel.
Wrong, yes. Everybody's been calling. Believe me, I got out of there early today, as I said. Wow.
Santana spoils a good pitch. What a year he's having, Jay. He's hit 5 home runs. That's a career high. In fact, he has more home runs this year than he's had through his entire career. And that's a couple of the newcomers. Peters, the left-hander. Scott Terry, the right-hander. Throwing in the Cardinal bullpen, so the brass doesn't like the way John Tudor has been working to this point. Fourth inning. Man at second, nobody out. That'll play, but it's not going to be easy. It's in that Bermuda Triangle, but Ozzy, he is such a gutsy key player, isn't he? He's out with the wind blowing out and everything, still to haul it in. Santana pops out. He's 0 for 2.
You'll see Ozzy go out here and take charge and make the play and
They turned his back to the infield and just sprinted out to where he thought the ball was going to come down, then turned around.
How about that play he made the other night in Montreal? Anybody else in the world make that play? I don't know.
And he's putting together his best season ever. This is the pitcher, Darling. He popped out to the first baseman when Herr made a fine play. They play him to hit into right field. And they're pretty deep in the outfield. Cardinal outfielders do play deep. But when you have Ozzy to run out and catch those pop-ups, that allows you to do that. And of course, Tommy Herr is very adept at that also. Up into the breeze, but not far enough. Vince Coleman will get this one. And he does for the second out.
The Cleveland Indians in the fourth inning, leading Minnesota now 4-1. Detroit did not score at Milwaukee in the first. Boston leads Baltimore 5-3 in the fourth inning. Toronto 2-1 over the Yankees in the fourth inning at Toronto.
Here we're in the bottom of the fourth, and it's 4-1 New York. Ogie Wilson with his ninth home run of the season, his last time up. New York club plays very well here at Shea Stadium. They've won 43 games. They're 43-28 at home. And these two clubs are tied, 6-6. Redbirds 3-3 here and 3-3 at Busch Stadium with New York. Six more to go, counting this one. We have these three, and then the last three of the 1987 championship season are at Busch Stadium against the New York Mets. Do you think we'll have this kind of media hype and enthusiasm in those three games, Jay?
Sure hope so.
Well, the Cubs stopped that Montreal winning streak today at 5. What is this, 13 or 14 consecutive days that the Cardinals have been in first place?
113.
113 days in a row, the Redbirds have been atop the National League East. As they come into this series, they're a game and a half out in front. New York is thinking about having that kind of lead when this three-game series is over. Another souvenir for one of the 50,000 here tonight. In the Cardinal fifth inning, Tudor is the fourth batter scheduled to hit, so the Cardinals have their bullpen busy. Howard Johnson singled, stole second. And he's still at second base with two down. Base open, Tudor can be careful to Santana if he wishes. Raphael. Mookie Wilson. He has that luxury of having the base open. 2-2 is the count. Tudor has come to the stretch a couple of times tonight and then stepped off. After getting his sign, he's acknowledged that and then started, but changed his mind and stepped off. He's had that kind of befuddled start. Good play. That keeps the runner at second base, but it runs the count to 3-2. And he's being careful to Mookie Wilson. Wilson has also been hot of late. In fact, this entire New York lineup has been playing extremely well offensively. Wilson has hit safely in 10 of his last 12.
Batted it better than 375 over that span.
And he's 1-for-2 tonight with a home run. Another foul out of play.
And let's pause 10 seconds for station identification along the Cardinals television network.
KSDK, Channel 5 in St. Louis.
St. Louis Cardinal baseball.
Boogie Wilson walks on that 3-2 delivery. The walk by Tudor is his third. Jay, I saw an interesting note about an article in the Dallas paper today about the commissioner of baseball levying a $250,000 fine against the Texas Rangers for bringing up pitcher Steve Howe without the commissioner's permission.
Now that fine against Mr. Childs down there.
That fine, by the way, is the maximum that the commissioner can fine a ball club, $250,000. The commissioner's office had no comment about that article, though, today. But it wouldn't surprise me. Tim Tuffle, the second baseman, he's having a good season. But Terry will take care of this, and the inning comes to a close. So Tudor pitches around the leadoff single and the walk. Matt Strand, a couple, they've left four. We've played four, and New York leads 4-1.
Out t-shirts and jerseys only to the youngsters. The Cardinals now have scheduled a new promotion offering t-shirts to the adults. That's coming up Thursday, October 1st. Adult t-shirt night, the Cards and the Expos. The first 35,000 fans, 16 and over, attending the game with a paid admission will receive a high-quality red and white t-shirt featuring the Birds on the Bat logo. Remember, that's October the 1st.
Third baseman, Terry.
Well, the Redbirds need to mount some offense. They trail by three runs as we go to the fifth inning. And they're facing a very tough starter tonight, Ron Darling, who's been on his game the last couple of months.
Pendleton has dropped below the 300 mark, but he has been double tough on the road this year. Pendleton batting 323.
And this is the first time he's been under the 300 mark, Jay, since April. All year long, they have seen the figure 300 plus behind Terry's name. But he started the night batting 299, and he's 0 for 1.
Marv Albert told me yesterday that he plans to have Pendleton on his pregame show for NBC tomorrow.
And news out of this Cardinal camp, as you see this fly ball tracked down by McReynolds, the left fielder. That's 10 in a row now retired by Ron Darling. Tony Pena has inked a new contract.
2 years. New deal with the Redbirds. And talking with him tonight, he said, I'm very happy it's been handled.
And, right fielder, John Morris.
The Cardinals are, too.
Yeah, those contract negotiations are always better when they're out of the way for both parties.
Cleveland's now leading Minnesota 7-1, fifth inning. Detroit at Milwaukee, they're scoreless, they're in the second.
Here's John Morris, he just lives down the road a bit. He's always played very well here at this ballpark in his short major league career. He got a ground ball RBI, his first time up tonight. That was in the second inning. That's the only run the Cardinals have been able to muster. Darling right now is working on a no-hitter.
And Morris on this year has done a good job off the bench. He has a club-high 8 pinch RBIs. He's playing in right field tonight.
That's been a trouble spot for Whitey Herzog all season long, that right field.
Well, and especially since Ford went down. I mean, it really has become a trouble spot since Kurt Ford was unable to perform out there.
Yeah, Ford held that post down pretty well through the middle half of the season, especially in the early part to middle half. Keith Hernandez once again with a play. And 11 in a row now retired by Darling. He's put a string together. He walked a man in the first inning. Got the double play when that hotline drive off the bat of Ozzie Smith deflected off of his pitching, or not his pitching hand, but his glove hand, and went directly to the shortstop in the air. Coleman was running, so he was double off. Then he walked Dreesen and McGee in the second inning, and since then, no one has been able to reach. He's set down all 11. He's a fate since McGee's walk in the second.
It put up a nice statistic on the board here regarding Steve Lake's play. He has committed only one error in 50 games behind the plate this year.
And he was robbed in the second inning by Santana, the shortstop, one of the better plays we've seen made against the Cardinals this year. He made an outstanding play, didn't he?
Well, and then Hernandez helped out scooping that ball out of the dirt over there at first the way he does. Boy, oh boy, a shot down the right side by Lake. Be something. All kinds of room as they shade way over to left for him.
Lance Johnson is in the on-deck circle, so he'll be the pinch hitter for Tudor if Lake can't get on. He's at the plate with two down, and he's in the hole one and two. There you see Lance. Fifth inning action, and so far, most of the action has been from the New York players. Two and two. We're in the fifth inning now at Cincinnati. Reds still leading 2-1. Pittsburgh's leading Philadelphia 2-0. Home run by R.J. Reynolds now in the seventh increases that lead. It's 3-0. The Dodgers got a home run from Bryant in the first. They lead 2-0 in the bottom of the fifth, and Houston plays at San Diego a little later on. Chicago beat Montreal today 8-4 at Wrigley Field, and that stopped their winning streak. Mets lead the Cards here 4-1. Struck him out far. Darling, that is strikeout number four, and he's retired 12 in a row now, and he has a no-hitter through five innings. That's come to bat, bottom of the fifth. They lead 4-1.
Eyewitness News update, the Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. Johnny's guest host tonight is comic Jay Leno, and his guest will be actress Carrie Fisher. At 11:30, stay tuned for Love Connection, followed by Late Night with David Letterman, his guest tonight. Rodney, I never get any respect, Dangerfield. That's all tonight, right here on Channel 5. Rodney Dangerfield. He got a little pub here in town. We snuck by there a time or two. There's the man's got the no-hitter going, rolling along here. The Mets lead it 4-1 as we go into the bottom of the fifth inning. Mike?
And the fellow that got the offense started tonight for New York is at the plate now, Keith Hernandez. He hit a ringing double to the left center field wall to put New York on top in the first. This guy has been one of the most consistent performers in the National League in the last 10 years. And he's up to his old tricks this season. He's tied his season high for home runs, 16. Came in hitting 303 with 75 RBI. He quickly added number 76 in the first inning. Vince Coleman will take care of the first out. See the wind really drift that ball back towards the wall. It is blowing from the right field pole towards the left field foul pole.
Strawberry.
And as Vince came in, he started in part. Watch him change directions now as the wind gets it. He straightens out and then has to go back. In the American League, the Yankees are playing at Toronto in a very big series. John against Flanagan in that game. They're in the fifth inning now, and the Blue Jays, who scored two in the first, lead 2-1. A hot shot off the bat of Darryl Strawberry. Man, when he hits the ball, he hits it very hard.
Mike, let me update you on that New York-Toronto action. They've just tied at the Yankees. They're batting in the fifth, 2-2.
Well, they're just with a run in, and there is the swing of Strawberry. He is some physical specimen, and when he gets the bat on the ball, it jumps, and it's shot right by the Cardinal first baseman, Dreesen. His second hit of the night. He got the biggest blow in this ball game, a two-run homer in the first inning, his 35th home run of the season. Baltimore is playing at Boston tonight. Benziger has hit a home run for the Red Sox, and Boston leads the Orioles 6-3 in the bottom of the fifth inning. Cleveland has hit Minnesota with six runs in the fourth, and they lead 7-1 in the fifth. Hall has hit two home runs in that game, his 13th and 14th. Henzo has hit his third. The Tigers are playing at Milwaukee, and they're scoreless in the bottom of the second. Here we're in the bottom of the fifth, and New York leads 4-1. And the Cardinals keep their bullpen busy. They still have Scott Terry, the right-hander, throwing. Devin McReynolds, with a base hit in the first inning, has extended his hitting streak to 7 games in a row, and during those 7, he's batted right at the 350 mark. He had a couple of home runs in his last 6 games also. So this New York club has really been generating some offense, Jay.
Yes, they have, and the Mets, incidentally, will meet the Cubs when the Cardinals go to Philadelphia. Uh-oh, they got him hung up.
Picked off, and Andreessen's throw is in time. Good tag by Ozzie Smith. Strawberry's cut down trying to steal. You know, the Mets lead the major leagues in only one department.
Left on base.
There's one that won't be left, though. He is marked down as out stealing. You see Andreessen get way over into the infield when he made that throw. Ozzie Smith with another piece of his magic. He throws out McReynolds, and that ends the inning. Base hit, but a man out stealing. We've played 5 at Gotham, with the Mets leading 4-1.
Coming up on the 29th, the Cardinals and the Montreal Expos at Busch Stadium, Optimus Club of Missouri, and Illinois night. And for ticket information, you can contact Charles Barnett at the Waterloo, Illinois Police Department. He's handling the ticket details. East Alton Wood River, Illinois night. And you can get tickets from John Kellner at the Illinois State Bank. That is Wednesday, September 30th. Johnson comes to the dish as a pinch hitter, batting 205. And here again is Mike Chen.
So John Tudor out of the ballgame after 5 innings. Lance Johnson with a bullet. And that's the way things have been going lately, folks. When the Redbirds hit a line drive, someone is making a sensational play. They have really been stung by some bad luck of late, haven't they, Jay?
Boy, oh boy. Keith Hernandez with a Gold Glove Award play, and they put it on the big message board here, and the fans react. Just another day at the office for Hernandez.
For John Tudor, he struck out 3 and he walked 3. He gave 4 runs, 7 hits, and 5 innings. And he leaves for the pinch hitter. This is a base hit for Vince, and he'll go. No, he decides to stay at first base.
Probably a good thing, too. The camera box down the right side juts out. That ball ricocheted back on the field, and Hernandez got to it very quickly, and it would have been close at second.
Very good drag bunt. Darling gets to it, but he has to reach out so far that he's diving and on his knees with the glove trying to flip it over there. Another infield single and a bunt single. Coleman's had better than a dozen bunt base hits this year. And in the infield single department, he's nearing the 40 mark.
He had retired 13 in a row.
Thanks to the great play by Hernandez to rob Johnson of an extra base hit. So Coleman gets the first base hit of the night, and the no-hitter is down the drain.
And Milwaukee takes a 1-0 lead over Detroit. They're in the third inning.
Ozzie Smith hit into a unfortunate double play in the first inning. He had a line drive, a bullet back to the mound. It went off the glove hand and arm of a pitcher, and it ricocheted from his arm into the glove of the shortstop. Now, something's wrong with Darling, and out comes the trainer and Davey Johnson all of a sudden. I mean, they popped out of that dugout almost immediately and simultaneously.
The trainer is Steve Garland, who is there on the left. Johnson, Howard Johnson comes in. Davey Johnson there. Now the entire infield gathering around, and they're going to have him throw a few pitches. Well, here's a man had a no-hitter going until that little bunt got Coleman on base, and now all of a sudden a must have some kind of a problem.
See him moving those fingers back and forth on his pitching hand. Boy, he's not throwing the ball very well in those warm-ups, Jay.
No, he threw two shots way high to the right. There's another one. Three high in the strike zone. I mean, high in the outside of the strike zone.
Yeah, he's hurting a little bit.
Obviously, something very wrong.
Yeah, he's. I'm going to doubt right now if he's going to be able to continue.
Could have pulled a muscle on this play.
Well, I think what he does is he jams his right hand into the turf there, and it gets turned underneath him a bit there. I think that's the problem.
Yeah.
He injured his right arm somehow, some way on that dive. When he went down, he was trying to throw it with his glove hand, and that left only his pitching hand, his right hand, to absorb some of that shock, and it looks like it got caught underneath him, and he's hurting a little bit. That's the best pitch now. That pitch he threw pretty well.
Yeah. It was a similar situation with Clark the other night when Clark went down at first base. He also hurt his wrist. We weren't really aware of it at the time, but he was breaking his fall, and that's how he strained the wrist.
He's not throwing very well at all right now. He's throwing one pitch. It's coming.
John
close
McSherry
into the strike zone. There's another one now that was pretty good. But
see big John McSherry there on the left. He although they've shaken up this crew, he is the crew chief of this group tonight.
He's going to try it.
Yep.
But he's hurting. I'll tell you that right now, Jay.
The Mets don't have anybody up and throwing yet, although they may as soon as Johnson gets on the phone. Now they're starting to stir out there.
Wind is really whistling here at the park tonight.
And they do get busy now in the Mets pen.
Yeah, I'm going to be surprised if he's going to be able to finish this game.
Myers is throwing.
The left-hander, Randy Myers. Coleman's on with a bunt single, the first hit in this ball game here in the sixth inning with one out. Yeah, he threw that ball pretty quickly over to first base. Darling has a good move over there. The outside corner.
San Francisco creeping back against the Reds. The Giants still batting in the sixth. And Cincinnati's lead is now 4-3. One run.
Dodgers still leading Atlanta 2-0. Pirates leading Philadelphia 3-0. There's outside and high with that fastball. Evens the count. New York infielders are shortened way up for the DP. Just an easy toss to first base this time. Cardinals trailing by only three. But the way the Redbirds have been going, three runs seems like quite a hill. Oh, very close over there. Hernandez makes one of the quickest tags you'll ever see in the game. And they get a lot of pickoffs because of Hernandez's quick tag. Another look at it. Watch how Keith gets that tag there in a big hurry. Boy, it was very close. But John McSherry right on top of the play. And Darling is being rather stubborn about throwing over there.
Mike, you're right. The wind is really beginning to whip up here.
Now it's blowing a pretty good gale from the right field foul pole to the left field foul pole. Yet another throw over there. This Darling has a quick move to first. Left-hander Randy Myers is still loosening in the New York bullpen. Sixth inning action. There you see the lefty. Into the seats again, and now Ozzie's in the hole, 1-2. Tonight, Darling has struck out four. He's walked three. And he's given only the one hit. That's the bunt single by Vince Coleman here in this inning. He has slowed it down appreciably, though. He's a fast worker. He's really slowing down now. And I would have to think it's due to the injury. Leisurely toss over that time. Here comes the pitching coach out. See, they don't like what they see right now. And I think that Mel Stottlemyre is going to ask him about this arm again. That's what they're talking about right here.
Mr. Stottlemyre could bring it in his day.
Pitch with the 1964 New York Yankees. There's Howard Johnson. David Johnson. He's a fellow that has a record. Most home runs by a second baseman. Also played on a team. Coleman's running. Carter's never thrown him out. And he still hasn't thrown him out. That's 27 out of 27 stealing against the New York Mets in his career.
And number 98 on the season.
And 12 of those 98 against the New York Mets this season. He's 12 out of 12 this year. 98. Get another look at it.
Pitch was outside. Carter came up firing, but Vince is there.
They sit here would put the cards only two back. Ozzie's only six RBIs away from tying a record also. Most RBIs by a man in a season without hitting a home run. He has 70 at the moment.
This fella had an MVP year. I tell you, Mr. Ozzie Smith.
Oh, you got picked off. You can't get picked off and you're trailing by three, but Vince Coleman does. That is a big, big play. Well, I'll tell you, the timing was great on that. Tuffle sneaked in behind him, and the throw was right there, and he was out. Ooh, that's a killer there, isn't it? So after stealing the base, he's picked off. Ooh. Ozzie spoils a tough pitch, and it's still 3-2. Ooh, what a cruncher that is.
Hey, you know, if you could pick up a run here, you still got a lot of time to do some damage. And you would have been able to make it a 4-2 game.
There's ball four. Walk number four.
Instead of having two on and one out, you got one on and two out for her.
Now that's not a good combination.
Not
from
good.
Two on and one out to
not
one on
good.
And two out. That's
good.
Going backwards, isn't it?
Yes, indeed.
Well, here's a fellow that's really struggling.
Oh boy.
Tommy Herr now is 0 for 15 and 2 out of his last 33. 0 for 2 tonight. He's flied to left and grounded to the first baseman, Keith Hernandez. Well, this big crowd has finally quieted down somewhat, Jay.
Yeah,
they get off to a roaring start tonight.
Really going early.
A little low. Darling is kind of gutting this one out, isn't he? That arm, hand, or whatever he injured when he dived for that bunt by Vince Coleman. He's taking a little of the sting out of it. Tommy Herr has hit only a couple of home runs this year. Another great play by Hernandez. Well, the Mets are doing it to the Cards tonight, aren't they? They're dancing all over the place. You won't see much better out of a first baseman than you just saw from Keith Hernandez, and he gets the glad hand, and he goes to the dugout, and Darling is still hurting a bit. Well, to the bottom of the sixth we go. Mets still holding on 4-1.
Back here at Shea Stadium as we move into the bottom of the sixth inning. We look at this play. Keith Hernandez getting it over to Ron Darling. Boy, oh boy. The new pitcher, Scott Terry. Tudor went five innings, gave up four runs, seven hits, struck out three, and walked three. And Terry has been getting a good deal of work on this road trip. Saw him on two occasions up in Montreal.
Cardinals are still looking for a right-hand relief pitcher that can come out of that bullpen and do the kind of job that Jeff Lottie did for so many seasons there. They've looked a lot of places, and now they've looked to Scott Terry. He came over from the Cincinnati Reds in the Pat Perry trade. There you see his record at the AAA affiliate of Cincinnati, Nashville, this season. He was up with Cincinnati at the first part of the year, and we saw this young man in spring training. The Cardinals tried to trade for Terry last season during the winter. And they finally made the deal just before the September cutdown date, cut down as far as the rosters are concerned for postseason play. It will be Carter. And he will be followed by Howard Johnson and Rafael Santana. They have no one throwing now in the New York bullpen. So Myers, who was throwing earlier, has stopped.
They also had Sisk up for a few moments out there. Well, our old friend Lee Trevino is leading the Boston Golf Classic at 133 after a couple of rounds. And of course, right over the way here tomorrow, the men's semifinals of the U.S. Open. It'll be Stefan Enberg to face Mats Wilander and top seeded Yvonne Lendl to oppose Belleville, Illinois' Jimmy Connors. That's another reason, Mike, you were talking about they've been urging the folks to take the buses and the trains around here. The U.S. Tennis Center just across the way here at Flushing, where the U.S. Open's going on. So lots happening in this area.
And not only is this game sold out here tonight, the game for tomorrow and Sunday has already been sold out. Scott Terry in his first inning of work. He's out in front of Gary Carter with a one ball, two strike count. We are in the sixth. It's 1-1-0 for the Cardinals, 4-7-0 for the New York Mets. Good look at Terry. Ah, he went around. And his first strikeout. Tudor, the starter, went five. He gave four runs, seven hits, struck out three, and walked three. Carter can't hold up as this slider is designed to look like the fastball. It does until it gets about 10 feet out in front of the plate, and then it dips and goes away. And Carter was fooled by that trickery. There have been a lot of changes in the world of baseball, especially in the pitching department, hasn't there, Jenny? You remember, about 25 years or so, they came up with the slider. Don Newcomb was one of the first guys to really develop that. Then the fork ball came along, and then along came a fellow by the name of Bruce Sutter, and he had what he called a split-fingered fastball. Now that thing has been improved on and is used by, I'll bet, half, if not more, than 50% of the pitchers in the National League anyway. Everywhere you go now, everybody's working on those split-fingered fastballs. At first, no one could seem to master it except for Bruce Sutter. Then Roger Craig jumped into the action, and he improved on it. And a guy by the name of Mike Scott developed it. Since then, they're throwing it everywhere.
I want to correct something we said earlier. I'd forgotten the day off yesterday. It's 114 consecutive days that the Cardinals have been in first place. And no matter what happens tonight, it'll be 115. But I'd like to see the Birds battle back here.
Good pitch. This guy, Howard Johnson, is trying for a home run record himself. He has hit 34 this year. And the home run record for a switch hitter in a season is 35. It's held by a Cardinal. Rip Collins did it back in 1934. Hojo, as they call him. And a tough play for Dreesen, and he makes it a lot of times. Fielder will let that base bother him. Dreesen didn't, and he makes the play unassisted. You don't know what to do if you're the fielder. You'd like to get to the ball before it gets to the base, but if you can't get there in time, you have to kind of lay back, because if it hits the base, it's going to take a different direction. Then a good play. As Dreesen first started in, then he saw that he couldn't get there in time. He hesitated, and the ball did miss the base, and it came to him. Good pitch.
Toronto goes back into the lead, fifth inning. They lead it 3-2 over the Yankees.
Here's a guy that's having his best season ever in the big leagues.
Sure is.
He's 0 for 2 tonight, but he has a six-game hitting streak, and his average is .266. He has 42 RBIs, and Santana has more home runs this year than he's had in his entire career. He's hit five.
He's played pretty well in the field for him, too.
What a play he made tonight. It was a big play, too. It cost the Cardinals a run, and they would have been trailing only by one. And who knows what happens after that. But when you get a key defensive play, it really takes the starch out of you.
This club has had about three or four already tonight, and that one ricochet double play back in the first inning.
Yeah, it happened up in Montreal, and the worm turned, as they say, and then it's happened here tonight. Second strikeout for Terry, so he has a very impressive 1-2-3 sixth. We've completed sixth. That's still leading, 4-1.
With Mike Shannon and with Mike Bush, Jay Randolph at Shea Stadium, New York, 4-1. The Mets lead it. They've outhit the Cardinals 7-1, and Danny Dreesen is ready to lead off in the seventh. Here again, Mike Bush.
It's getting late. Where are all the runs?
It's been tough on this road trip.
4-7-0 for the Mets. 1-1-0 for the Cardinals. Ron Darling throwing a one-hitter. The only hit, a Vince Coleman bunt single in the sixth inning. It'll be Dan Dreesen, Willie McGee, and Terry Pendleton for the Cardinals. 4-1, the Mets lead it. First pitch to Dan. That misses outside. 1-0. Dreesen walked in the second and scored on a fielder's choice. Flied out in the fourth. So he's 0 for 1. And it's 2-0 to the Cardinal first baseman, playing in place of Jack Clark, who of course will miss the three-game series with the Mets with a sprained wrist and a sprained ankle. 2-1 now to Dan Dreesen. The Cubs beat Montreal this afternoon at Wrigley 8-4. Pirates leading the Phillies 3-1. Dreesen fouls it back. That now in the eighth inning in Philadelphia with the Phillies at bat. San Francisco trying to come back against Cincinnati. They trailed 4-1. The Reds still leading in the seventh, 4-3 now. And the Dodgers ahead of Atlanta 5-0 in the seventh. Jumps out of the way. 3-2. Full count to Dan Dreesen. Cardinals need some base runners to make something happen. Dreesen will be followed by McGee and then Pendleton. Darling misses, and the Cardinals have their leadoff man on base in the person of Dan Dreesen. Dreesen walks for the second time.
That's the fifth walk given up by Darling, and that's a little more than usual from him.
He's one of these guys that likes to paint the corners, and you can see him struggling a little bit. However, as we mentioned at the top, he has only given up one hit so far, and it was a bunt single by Vince Coleman. There's a look at Dave Johnson and
Trainer coming back out to take a look at him with Johnson, and they may decide here just to take him out. That is Steve Garland, the trainer. Well, while we have them talking things over, let's remind you about October the 1st at Busch Stadium, the Cards in Montreal, Ferguson, Missouri night. For ticket information, contact Ralph Rockerman at SportSprint. And for all of you listening, to have your name placed on a preferred list for 88 season tickets, you can call the Cardinal Sales Department, 425-0600. That's 425-0600, area code, of course, 314. And this is going to be all for Darling.
Well, what a performance by Ron Darling, and he's going to get a standing ovation from the Shea Stadium crowd. And as the new pitcher comes in from the bullpen, We'll pause for these commercials and we'll be right back with the Mets leading 4-1.
Randy Myers, the left-hander, he is from the state of Washington, born in Vancouver, and he lives in the interesting little town of Brush Prairie, Washington. And you can see that he's been used a lot this year, a 4.15 ERA. At Tidewater last year, he was 6-7. No decisions, up with the big club late. He played in 10 games. And the left-hander is 0-1 with two saves and an 0.196 ERA in his last 14 games over 18.2 innings. He's pitched very, very well in recent weeks.
And he's pitching now to Willie McGee with Dan Dreesen on first base, 1-0 to Willie, who now turns around and bats from the right side. Willie walked in the second and flied out in the fourth. 1-0 pitch on the way inside, and it's 2-0. Dreesen led off the inning with a walk. Ron Darling experiencing difficulty in his motion. He was banged out and around a little bit out there on the mound tonight. Deflected an Ozzie Smith line drive earlier in the game. And in a little trouble with his pitching motion. And so now he comes out after pitching a one hitter through six full innings. Dan Dreesen, the runner at first. Myers has thrown three straight balls to Willie McGee. Cardinals trying to get something started here in the seventh. The Mets lead it 4-1. 3-0 pitch right down the middle. 3-1. The Mets scoring three in the first and one in the second. The Cardinals getting their only run on a fielder's choice in the second inning. 3-1 pitch on the way. Willie fouls it back to the right side and out of play. 3-2. Willie 0-for-1 with a walk. McReynolds, Wilson, and Strawberry in left, center, and right. Johnson, Santana, Tuffel, and Hernandez, the infield third to first for the Mets. Swinging a ground ball. This could be two. Over to second for one. Relay not in time. Willie beat it out. So really the Cardinals, though they would like to have gotten runners at first and second, are really in better shape now with McGee running the bases than with Dreesen. It was a slow hit ground ball, so Willie was able to hustle down that first baseline and beat it out. One out, and here comes Terry Pendleton. Terry grounded into a fielder's choice in the second, but he did his job moving the base runners along and helped the Cardinals score their only run of the game so far. Big swing and a miss by Terry, 0-1.
And a good fastball by the left-hander.
Jerry also flied out in the fifth, so he's 0-for-2. Came into the game hitting .299. It's been a long time since Terry Pendleton has been below the 300 mark. 0-1 pitch by Myers, another good pitch, and it's 0-2. So he starts off by throwing three straight balls to McGee, and he gets Willie to ground into a fielder's choice, and now he comes 0-2 on Terry Pendleton.
And the Mets have Sisk up and throwing.
Nothing and two to the Cardinal third baseman. McGee gets the lead at first. Here's the pitch. High and outside. 1-2. Wasted one. John Tudor started the game for the Cardinals. Got into trouble. There's a good look at
Sisk. Now McDowell
right
with him.
Roger McDowell. John gave up three runs in the first inning to the Mets. And then another home run to Mookie Wilson in the second. And then he settled down and pitched more like the John Tudor we've come to expect. However, by that point, the Mets were already in front 4-1. 4-7-0 for New York, 1-1-0 for the baseball Cardinals. One ball and two strikes to Terry Pendleton. Again, Myers goes to first. The Cardinals got their only run in the second inning. Dreesen walked. McGee walked, a couple of fielder's choices, and the Morris fielder's choice to Keith Hernandez scored Dan Dreesen. Meyer strikes out Terry Pendleton, and there are two gone. Well, what looked to be a promising inning with a Dan Dreesen leadoff walk has now become two outs and a man on first. And we're going to have a pinch hitter. John Morris, the right fielder, is due up, but David Green has picked up a bat on the on-deck circle.
Green, the former Red Bird who had such a sensational performance down at Louisville, hitting over 350. Fellow who is trying to get back into the major league swing of things. At Louisville, he hit 351 with 33 RBIs, five home runs. Had 24 doubles in 202 times at bat.
David Green.
Cardinals need to get something going. David Green pinch hitting for John Morris, who is 0 for 2 tonight. That was a good look at the arithmetic of David Green when he was down at AAA Louisville. Willie McGee the runner at first. Randy Myers, the new pitcher for the Mets, throws over towards McGee. There are two outs. We're in the seventh. Here's the pitch. That misses. 1-0 to David Green, who came in and replaced Jack Clark the other night in Montreal when Clark went down with the sprained wrist and sprained ankle. Went 1-for-2 on Wednesday. Another throw Willie McGee's way.
Watching Green in the batting cage taking batting practice the other night in Montreal. Boy, he really boomed some shots at Olympic Stadium.
Here's the 1-0 pitch to Green. Big swing and a miss. 1-1. Well, he's going up there swinging. Cardinals need something to get started here in the seventh inning. They're trailing 4-1. They only have one hit. Now they've got McGee picked off. McGee was so frustrated, he sort of just stopped in his tracks and went, doggone it.
Second man that has been picked off by the Mets tonight. And, you know, when we lost Coleman back in the sixth, it was a very tough situation.
So the Cardinals started this inning promisingly and then get nothing out of it. We played 6.5 here at Shea Stadium with the Mets on top, 4-1.
And batting seventh, number 18, David Green
takes over in right field. And we're going to have a pinch batter, Lenny Dykstra, for Randy Myers. Oh, Darling went six innings, gave up a run on one hit, struck out four, and he walked five.
Ron Darling, number four. Lenny Dykstra.
So Len Dykstra will pinch hit for Randy Myers, and very important inning for the Cardinals right here. They're trailing 4-1. They cannot afford to give up any more runs. What I want to know is, why is this such a loud stadium with a huge crowd and planes flying overhead, and the only thing that's silent right now are the Cardinal bats?
I wish I could answer that question for you. I'm sure they wish they could answer with some hits.
Scott Terry is the pitcher. The right-hander came in replace of John Tudor in the sixth and struck out two and got Howard Johnson to ground out.
Dykstra hitting 276 on the year. Dykstra earned his big chance when Mookie Wilson was injured in the spring of 86, and he's been a handy man here. He has 9 home runs, 32 runs batted in.
0-2 pitch by Terry. Fouled. Still 0-2. In Cincinnati, the Reds are now at bat in the seventh. And they're still leading the Giants 4-3. With a win, the Reds can move to within four games of the National League Western Division Giants.
Milwaukee still leads Detroit. The Tigers are batting at Milwaukee in the fifth inning. 1-0 Milwaukee. Toronto now 4-2 over the Yankees. Toronto batting in the sixth at Exhibition Stadium, Toronto.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch to Dykstra. This one will fall fair into left field. Dykstra turns the corner at first. He's headed to second. He'll stop there with a double. Well, you probably can hear the crowd in the background. And one of the reasons why is because there's 51,795 paid tonight. 53,766 in the house. And there's a good look at Lenny Dykstra going the other way with it. And after it bounced fair, it rolls toward the wall over there. And Dykstra is in with a leadoff double here in the seventh.
Mookie Wilson, 1-for-2. Has a home run tonight.
First pitch by Terry. He bunts it. It's a good bunt. Terry's got to go to first. He's out. Close play at first base.
A bang bang play, and here it is. Wilson with the bunt. Terry got to it quickly, and he had to. Mookie has great speed. He just nipped him. The sacrifice as Dykstra goes to third. One out.
So Lenny Dykstra at third, and here comes Tim Tuffle. He singled and scored in the first, walked in the second, and grounded into a fielder's choice in the fourth. The attendance, by the way, of 53,766, the largest paid crowd here at Shea. Ground ball second base. Herr coming home with it. The throw, they've got him. A good play by Tommy Herr as Dykstra just came down the line hard. The infield was pulled in, and Herr made a good throw to Steve Lake, who did a great job of blocking the plate, and they get Lenny Dykstra.
Tom didn't hesitate. The shot to him, the infield drawn in a little bit. You'll see where he got this ball, and he came home. Lake does a nice job. He's got the plate blocked and makes the tag.
First baseman.
Got another look at it.
Hernandez.
Isolation at the plate. Lake with the tag.
You're a young catcher. That's exactly the way to do it. You block the plate and you keep that runner from just going straight on in. He's got to slide around you one way or the other. And Steve Lake did a great job. So there are now two outs. This is the St. Louis Cardinals Baseball Television Network.
KSDK, Channel 5 in St. Louis.
So Keith Hernandez steps up with two outs and just a runner on first base. Scott Terry trying to get out of the inning. Little inside, 1-0.
Just giving us some word about Darling leaving the game. First of all, he hurt his left wrist when that ball was hit in the first inning off the bat of Ozzie Smith. And then he hurt his right hand, actually the thumb on the right hand, when we had that play a little later on.
There's a base hit by Hernandez up the middle, so you can see what a important play that Tommy Herr throw to the plate was, because Hernandez just singles up the middle, and there are two on for the Mets with two outs. Darryl Strawberry about to step in, but here comes Whitey Herzog. Not to talk to Scott Terry, and he's already signaled to the bullpen.
And you saw that patented swing of Keith Hernandez sending it through the middle. They don't expect that Darling would have to miss a turn because of the problems he had here tonight. And that is all for Scott Terry. Cardinal hand. It is Strawberry standing in
against Steve Peters. Got to get out of a jam. Two men on, two out. Mets leading 4-1. Here's the pitch. Ball one. Strawberry, a home run in the first, a two-run shot. He struck out in the third, and he had a single in the fifth. He is swinging a hot bat. There is a look at the arithmetic on Steve Peters.
Scott Terry went 1 2/3. He gave up 2 hits, struck out 2, and walked none. And the two men on belong to him, of course.
1-0 pitch, 2-0. Steve has got to be careful. 3 runs down, the Cardinals are capable of coming back, but the way they've been hitting lately, you don't want to get into a bigger hole. 3-0 to Darryl Strawberry. On deck is Kevin McReynolds. This is the man that Whitey Herzog called on to get out Strawberry, because you've got a right-handed hitter on deck. But you don't want to groove one either. 3-0 pitch. Good pitch. 3-1. Two outs. Bottom of the seventh. The Mets lead it 4-1. 4-9-0 for New York. 1-1-0 for the Cardinals. A bunt single by Vince Coleman. 3-1 pitch on the way. Foul back. 3-2.
In the eighth inning in Atlanta, the Braves have come up with a couple, and it's 5-2 LA.
Big pitch right here. 3 balls and 2 strikes to this guy. Darryl Strawberry hit 2 home runs against Philadelphia Wednesday, then hit another one in the first inning tonight. A towering drive to right field. Payoff pitch. Again, fouled back. Still 3-2.
Final score at Philadelphia. The Pirates win it 4-2.
John Tudor, the starter for the Cardinals, relieved by Scott Terry and Steve Peters, the Cardinals' third pitcher of the evening. 2 on, 2 out, 3-2 pitch. Strike 3. Good pitch by Steve Peters.
Oh, dandy. Took a little something off of it and it mesmerized Strawberry.
And the Cardinals are out of the inning.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the Mets get 2 hits, but nobody across. And after 7 complete here at Shea, the Mets 4, the Cardinals 1. Cap is the most popular hat in town these days, and you can get one free if you attend the Cardinals Pirates game on Thursday, September 24th at 7:35 p.m. The first 40,000 fans with a paid admission will receive the traditional red mesh cap featuring the St. Louis Cardinals logo, and you can help turn Busch Stadium into a sea of red as you root for the Redbirds against the Pirates. That's Cap Day, September 24th. The new pitcher for the New York Mets is right-hander Roger McDowell, with a record of 7-5 and a 3.84 earned run average. He comes in with 23 saves. He's pitched a lot of baseball, 77 innings. And to start the Cardinal rally, here's Jay Randolph.
Well, I hope we can do that. Green will be the batter. He was at the plate, you'll remember, when we had McGee picked off to end the seventh inning. O'Green to face McDowell. McDowell, the right-hander, has 6 saves and is unscored upon in his last 8 games. Green is out number one. The Mets have gotten some fine performances out of the bullpen as we look at Hojo, Howard Johnson, make this play to cut down Green. Green can still run. I mean, run very well. Jose Oquendo is the pinch hitter. The secret weapon standing in. Lake was 0 for 2 while he was in there. Mike Laga comes out on deck. A little high to Oquendo. 301's the average, 23 runs batted in, and a homer for Jose. That's a strike on the inside corner. Roger McDowell, born in Cincinnati, Ohio, 14-9 last year with a 3.02 ERA for the Mets. Foul back, 1 ball and 2 strikes.
Had some injury problems at the beginning of this year, and When he finally did make his way to the mound, he had some control problems. He's a sinker ball pitcher, and he wasn't getting the sinker ball over the plate. But he is back to form, and it's 1-2 on Jose.
That gets by Gary Carter. 2-2. Well, the Mets have really been perking, and the Cardinals have been struggling, having a lot of trouble scoring runs, a club that averaged almost 5.5 runs over the season until the 1st of August. Scored only 5 runs up in Montreal in 3 games. 1 run here tonight, 3-2 the count.
They're in the 8th now in Cincinnati. Reds still leading the Giants 4-3. Pittsburgh beat Philadelphia 4-2. It's 4-1 here at Shea Stadium in New York with the Mets on top.
And a walk to Oquendo. The Cardinals have a base runner, and here is Mike Laga. Laga up from Louisville. Hit 296, 29 home runs, and 95 runs batted in. Laga was with the club early in the year.
One of those, obviously this guy's got a lot of power, and it'd be nice if he could hit home run number 30 on the year. First in the bigs for the season. This guy is a tremendous minor league power hitter.
I think he hit one home run earlier in the year.
Did he?
Yep, I believe so. On the year with the Cardinals, he's batting 167, and I'll double check that. But as I remember, he had a home run earlier in the year.
This is the guy who has so much power that last year hit a foul ball out of Busch Stadium.
That's the truth. He did.
I mean, over the roof.
Third. Well, after making a couple of brilliant plays tonight, Hernandez just let that one go right through. The ball didn't come up to him. So the Redbirds have an opportunity here.
Well, you may have seen it earlier. Hernandez made a couple of tremendous plays back in the sixth inning. This one, the Cardinals sin, thought the ball was going to come up. It stayed down. His glove came up. And now the Cardinals have runners at first and third and only one out, and they've got to get some runs in. Here's Vince Coleman.
And Laga did hit a home run earlier this year for the Cardinals, just to set that straight. The error. And two on, one out. And here's Coleman. He has walked, struck out, bunted his way on. Cardinals still only have one hit, but they have the tying run at the plate. One ball to count to Coleman.
Just hope Vince is swinging for a base hit. He had that one out of the park home run earlier this year, and he seemed to get a kick out of it, but I think he
well, we get a kick out of it right now. Yeah. But I think we just like to have something happen.
Yeah.
The Redbirds have been stalled in the offense department and lost the first three of this road trip up in Montreal. Roger McDowell in a little trouble. There the brain trusts. We are in the eighth inning.
Tell you what, Jay, the infield is playing at double play depth. I'm not so sure a bunt here wouldn't be a bad idea.
There's a strike at the letters. Two balls and one strike to Coleman. Final at Boston. The Red Sox beat Baltimore 9-3. Four, 9-1 for the Mets, 1-1-0 for the Cardinals. Two and two.
Coleman with the only Cardinal hit of the night, even though he's the tying run to the plate right now, had a bunt single.
And he stole a base in that sixth inning and then got picked off.
That really hurt.
Two on, one out. And the 2-2 pitch coming from Roger McDowell. And a high chopper. Can they get to? Yes!
He should be.
I want to take a look at that. It could have been a 4-2 game if Coleman beat it, but the crew chief said Coleman was out, and it's a double play. Well, we'll take a look at it right now.
Here's the swing. You see it hits it right in front of the plate. So it slowed up just a little bit. Tuffle's got to hurry. Santana now over to first. Watch it carefully. Oh, he's safe. It wasn't even close.
Well,
he beat it by half a step.
Let's take a look at another angle.
He's safe.
Yeah, sure was.
And that cost the Cardinals a run.
Yes, indeedy. That's the way it's been going. It's 4-1, Mets. He is the new catcher for the Cardinals. And we have a new battery. Steve Tunnel, or Lee Tunnel, excuse me, is the new pitcher. So Tunnel and Pagnozzi. Tunnel following Tudor, Terry, and Peters to the mound. Kevin McReynolds leads it off. He's 1-for-3. Oh, that call at first base is a killer, but that's the way things have been going, Mike. The Redbirds just haven't had it going their way.
No kidding.
I hope the worm will turn.
Wasn't for bad luck, it'd be no luck at all right now.
In center field, McGee, one out.
Those are the kinds of calls that they were getting, it seemed, the first half of the season.
Well, when you're going good, things go your way. And when you're going bad, they just seem to pile up and pile up on the other side of the ledger. Gary Carter has walked, grounded out, and struck out this evening. The Mets are leading at 4-1, bottom of the eighth inning. Looking ahead to the Cardinal ninth, Smith, Herr, Breeson, and hopefully a lot more. One strike to Carter.
Of course, if the Mets win this game, it will be within a half a game of first place.
To the count. Now Minnesota's trying to come back at Cleveland. Double by Randy Bush scored Steve Lombardozzi and Greg Gagne. Two runs in. They have one on and two out. Cleveland leading 8-7. Top of the eighth inning. Stopped by Pagnozzi. Baltimore lost to Boston 9-3. 9-15-1 for Boston. 3-9-0 for Baltimore. The winner was Sellers. Barrett got the game-winning RBI. Detroit and Milwaukee are now 1-1 in the sixth inning. Cleveland is batting now in the eighth. Their lead cut to one. It's 8-7 against Minnesota. Toronto leading 4-3 over New York in the seventh. This is popped up. Pendleton. Two gone.
Howard Johnson
hit into a double play, singled, and stole his 30th base of the year to move into that 30-30 club, and he grounded out in the sixth.
Jay, really an amazing year for Howard Johnson. Really becomes the first full-time infielder to ever join the 30-30 club.
That's right.
He's had a tremendous season, and a lot of people felt, we were talking earlier in the game, how Ray Knight left the ball club for less money to go to the Baltimore Orioles, and a lot of people felt that that would hurt the Mets, but it sure hasn't, because this guy has come in and done a whale of a job. He leads the team in RBIs, ahead of Strawberry, ahead of McReynolds, ahead of Carter.
0-2.
There's been a lot of talk of corking the bats, and Howard Johnson has had his share of bats confiscated this year, but they've all been legitimate.
Check swing.
Nelson coaching down there at third, throwing that ball up into the stands. Bill Robinson coaches first base here. Just inside. One ball and two strikes. Coleman, McGee, and Green now in the Cardinal outfield, left to right. Bagnozzi doing the catching. Third base, that's Perlozo, who is coaching tonight down there, and not Buddy Harrelson, normally is there. And Ozzy coming, and in time. Johnson grounds out, tunnel comes on, and gets them 1-2-3. So we head into the bottom of the ninth. That's lead it. Or we head into the top of the ninth, I should say. Mets lead at 4-1. 4-1. Cardinals out hit 9-1 here.
Shortstop, Ozzie
Smith leading it off. The Wizard lined into a double play, a weird play that went off the glove of Darling to Santana, who doubled up Coleman in the first. Then he struck out and walked again.
Guess that play in the first inning was an omen of things to come.
Well, we talked about it happening, a very similar situation on Monday night in Montreal, and then it happened here again tonight. The Cardinals have had trouble getting the lead. It's really been tough for them. They have had a lot of trouble scoring. Held to one run at this point in the proceedings tonight. Strike on the outside corner, 2-1.
And when you're rallying like that or threatening to score runs and you're in the first inning and a freak play takes you out of the inning, that really has got to let the air out of the balloon a little bit.
Three balls and one strike. Ozzy chatting with Terry Tate of the plate umpire.
How about one of these ninth inning comebacks?
Sounds good to me. Right down central, 3-2.
Cardinals have made a couple of base running mistakes tonight. Vince Coleman and Willie McGee were both picked off at different times. Again, their only hit.
All right.
Was a bunt single.
That's a start.
Here we go.
Even though it's just a walk.
Stepping up.
For McDowell, his second pass. Here is Herr. Tommy Herr is mired in a 2-for-36 slump. And this would be a nice time to bust out of it. A bruised left wrist suffered in the first inning and a sprained right thumb sustained in the sixth. Did Darling in. Boy, he pitched six innings, gave up only the one run, one hit, struck out four and walked five. Inside to Tommy Herr. Hurlers are up in the bullpen for the Mets. Orozco is up now. They start the chant, "Let's go Mets" here. There's a strike, one ball and one strike to Tommy Herr.
The Mets playing for the double play with Ozzie Smith at first. The outfield straight away.
Cardinals need base runners. Herr fouls it out of play off to the left side. Cleveland now leading Minnesota 10-7. Boy, they're having some fun on the lakefront in Cleveland tonight. They're in the eighth inning and Cleveland is still batting. Detroit and Milwaukee are still 1-1. They're in the seventh. Toronto's batting at Toronto, leading 4-3 over the Yankees. They're in the seventh inning. San Francisco batting in the eighth at Cincinnati. Reds leading 4-3. Here it's 4-1 Mets. That's high, 2-2.
Jay Ozzie's getting a pretty good lead at first base because Keith Hernandez is not holding him on the bag. Really, his run doesn't mean anything.
That's right, and with her, of course, the left-handed batter, they like him playing off the bag there to cut down the room. And Hernandez makes a fine play. Ozzie goes on to second, but her grounds out, and he's now two for his last 37.
Well, there is no finer first baseman in baseball than Keith Hernandez, and that is really a tough play. That ball skipping and slicing away from him, and he made the smart play. Ozzie had it beat it at second base, so Keith just stepped on the bag at first, and now there is one out, and here's Dan Dreesen.
Dreesen scored the Cardinals' only run. He led off with a walk in the second, later scored on a grounder by Morris. He's lined out in the fourth, walked again in the seventh. One on and one out, ninth inning, 4-1 Mets. That's high. One ball and one strike.
Time, but Dreesen became a Major League Baseball player because he went for a tryout, one of those Cincinnati Reds tryouts when they go all across the country, and one of the Red scouts saw him and signed him up. Had some great years with the Big Red Machine in the 70s.
The 1-1 pitch, fouled away. 1-2.
About reliving some of those years, Danny. Right now,
Dreesen down at Louisville. He didn't like it one little bit being in the minors. He wants to try and showcase himself a bit here at the end of this season in hopes of latching on to a major league job. He said if he had to go back to the minors, he'd probably pack it in. Ozzie out there at second, one out. First strikeout for McDowell, and McDowell and the Mets are one out of away from moving within half a game of the Redbirds.
Well, that's what McDowell does best. Look at that ball, just drops off the table, and Dan had sort of made his move. There was nothing he could do to hold back, and now there are two gone, and the Cardinals' last hope is Willie McGee.
Willie walked in the second, slid to left in the fourth, reached on a fielder's choice, and was picked off in the seventh. Fouled away. Well, this big crowd coming to its feet now. They're on their feet all around. There are signs up. Half a game signs. As I look around, you see some of these folks. They've had a big night here. They're making the signs as they go along. Only one hit, half a game. It's not over yet. But the Cardinals need McGee to get on and then something to happen. They're down 4-1, ninth inning. 0-2. And they're roaring on every pitch now. McGee against McDowell. Just outside. One ball and two strikes. This huge crowd, a jam-packed Shea Stadium, watching their world champions trying to repeat in the National League East. Trying to get within a half game. And the Cardinals are still alive. Here comes Ozzie, and it is a 4-2 game, and the tying run will come to the plate. McGee delivers with a single up the middle and the RBI, his 97th of the season,
as Ozzie comes home.
Well, you know what they say, it's not over till it's over, and Willie McGee says it's not over yet. Ground ball right past back, past Roger McDowell's glove, up back the middle, and Ozzie scored easily from second. And here's Terry Pendleton, and Terry is the tying run.
Pendleton is 0 for 3. Fouled it away. He came up there cutting. Pendleton's average dipping below the 300 mark for the first time in a long, long time. Roger McDowell trying to close the door on this one. Pendleton trying to keep it going. Ninth inning, 4-2 Mets. Pendleton hits the long one into center field.
Get out of here.
Wilson
of
going here. Back. It is out of here. And it's tied up at 4-4. Terry Pendleton.
Well, you gotta love it. Terry Pendleton hit it to the deepest part of this ballpark.
That wind blowing that way from right to left here. That's another home run for the Cardinals, and the quality builders at Taylor Morley Simon will make a donation to the Special Olympics in Terry's name. Taylor Morley Simon invites you to visit Polo Run near Creve Coeur. Three unique communities in one with a home choice for every buyer. And maybe they'll double the donation with that one.
Let's take a look at Roger McDowell's reaction after that one. Thought it might have a chance to stay in. Blows the bubble gum and goes, uh-oh.
And the bubble just burst for this big crowd and the Mets. And the Cardinals have battled back. Now David Green puts it through. And Green is going to go for two. The big guy is there. And the go-ahead run is out there at second base.
Now that's Cardinal baseball at its best. The Cardinals manufacturing runs, taking the extra base. And David Green did that on just a short base hit into shallow left center field. He turned the corner at first, head first sliding safe into second. Here it is again. Mookie Wilson sort of nonchalanting it out there in center field. Didn't think Green was going to go for two, but he's there at second base. And he is the go-ahead run for the baseball Cardinals. The Cardinals have been out hit 9-4, but we're all tied up at four here in the ninth inning.
And Tom Pagnozzi comes to the dish for the first time. He's batting 184, has two home runs, has eight runs batted in. Big spot for the youngster. Down the right side, foul ball.
The man of the hour, Terry Pendleton. Yeah. Pagnozzi hit that ball right on the nose. That would have scored the run easily. But it went foul by a couple of feet.
Cardinals one pitch away from defeat. Yet the two-run home run, a dramatic shot by Pendleton. Fouled off and out of play. 0-2. Ozzie had a couple of good cuts.
But this would do for their confidence.
Boy, it would stop the slide. It would be a big turnaround to win this first game of this three-game series. Just outside. One ball and two strikes.
Tough situation for the youngster. He sure would like to bring home David Green. Veteran pitcher on the mound.
2-2. And he strikes out. Well, they were roaring on every pitch here a few moments ago, and now they're booing. It's a 4-4 game. The Mets were within one pitch of victory, and we've got a whole new ball game. We'll go to the bottom of the ninth, tied at four. 4-4 tie. Now Whitey Herzog coming out to talk to the plate umpire, Terry Tatum. And now he is going out to the hill, and it looks like he's made up his mind to replace Tunnel, even though he hadn't even thrown a pitch here in the ninth.
He's playing cat and mouse with Davey Johnson. The Mets announced Lee Mazzilli as the pinch hitter.
Uh-huh. Well, that's...
And so before even... before Tunnel even threw a pitch, he takes him out. And
Mazzilli was announced for Santana.
Here comes Ken Daly out of the bullpen.
Well, Daly will be the fifth pitcher of the evening. Tudor started and went five. Was followed by Terry and Peters and Tunnel. Daly, of course, is a remarkable story. One of the really great comeback stories in baseball this year or any year. And he gets the call to go against Mazzilli.
And I think a guy you'd rather have in this position going into the bottom of the ninth against the Mets than Lee Tunnel, who has struggled a little bit this year.
Well, Tunnel has had some injury problems, of course. In that Pittsburgh-Philadelphia final, the winning pitcher was Drabek, the loser Gross. Tony Pena now behind the plate. So Pena takes over for Pagnozzi, who had taken over for Lake. And Ken Daly is appearing in his 45th game. He is 8-4. Very fine, 2.06 ERA. Toronto leading 5-3 over the Yankees at Toronto. New York bats in the eighth inning. Detroit at Milwaukee, they're still 1-1 in the eighth. Cleveland leading Minnesota 10-8. They're in the ninth, Minnesota batting. Kansas City is underway at Oakland. They did not score in the first. San Francisco's now batting in the top of the ninth at Cincinnati, down 4-3. Lee Mazzilli, once the toast of this town when he first came on board with the Mets, been around a little bit since, and now back in a Mets uniform.
A big contributor to their drive last year down the stretch. Good guy to have coming off the bench because he's a veteran and he's got a good eye. Doesn't usually swing at bad pitches.
Well, it's been great to see this comeback by the Cardinals here tonight. You'll have an opportunity, of course. The Cardinals play 13 of their last 16 games at Busch Stadium, and you can get involved with that Busch beer push for $3 million. The discount tickets, the information at many retail outlets. Get on the bandwagon. Busch beer and the push for 3 million fans at Busch Stadium this season. Mazzilli stands in. Ken Daly's first pitch is low.
Tony Pena is heading toward the dugout. I think he needs a piece of equipment repaired, or needs to add a piece of equipment. There's some tape.
They're going to put the tape on his fingers so that Daly can see the signs. That's happened a number of times this year. Gene Gieselman doing the handiwork, the Cardinals' fine trainer who I nicknamed years ago Dr. Feelgood, and it stuck. He's quite a fella. What a job he's done. Of course, he's been working.
Busy guy this year. Too busy.
Yes, indeed. Mazzilli to the right side. Oh, a fine play by Dreesen. My goodness, he went to his right and just did get to that ball.
Even he liked it. Had a big smile on his face.
Oh, boy.
Well, he had to make sure of the out. And you can see a line drive. It was a soft liner off the bat of Mazzilli. Andreessen making sure, keeping his eye on the ball and squeezing it. And there's one out here on the bottom of the ninth. And here's the veteran, Bill Allman.
Billy Allman as a pinch hitter. Batting 239. McDowell went two innings and he gave up three runs on three hits. He struck out two and he walked two. No balls and two strikes to Bill Allman.
Jay, I think the new pitcher for the Mets will be Jesse Orozco, who continues to warm up.
He
in the
was
bullpen.
Throwing out there.
Still is.
All right.
It's a little low.
One ball and two strikes. There's Orozco. Two and two.
The Mets scored three in the first, one in the second. The Cardinals scored one in the second and three in the ninth. We're tied 4-4, one out, bottom of the ninth inning.
Three in the ninth, punctuated by the home run by Pendleton. This just over the outstretched glove of Pendleton. And the winning run at first with one out here in the ninth. Allman comes through.
Allman made a big turn at first base, but Coleman did a good job of hustling the ball and throwing it into the infield. Allman hammered that one. It's a line drive just over the outstretched glove of Terry Pendleton, who was hit pretty hard, and that allowed Coleman to get to it before Allman could stretch it into a double. And being the game-winning run, Allman did not want to take any chances.
Mookie Wilson has struck out, homered, walked, and sacrificed. Mookie looked like he wanted to punt. Ball gets by. The throw is high, and now the winning run is at second.
Well, let's see it again. There's Wilson, like a notion to bunt, had to take it inside. Tony Pena was coming up.
I throw down to lose it. They'll score it as a pass ball, I would think. Wants to talk things over with Daly. Whitey Herzog marches down in the dugout. Cardinals tying this one up in the ninth, and now the Mets with a chance to win it.
Looks like that everybody that came tonight here to Shea Stadium is still here. At least they're making as much noise as they ever were.
Cardinals had only one run on one hit until they got the three in the ninth. Fouled out of play. One ball and one strike. In the ninth, Smith was walked. Her grounded out, Greason struck out. Then with two out, a single by McGee to keep it going, and the home run by Pendleton. Single by McGee up the middle, got Smith on. The 1-1 pitch, high. Two balls and one strike.
Jay, in Milwaukee, the Tigers now lead the Brewers in the eighth inning, 2-1.
Sparky Anderson's bunch. They've made a big, big run. Final, Cincinnati beats San Francisco 4-3. Another foul, backing out of play. 2-2.
Nobody warming up in the Cardinal bullpen. It's all up to Ken Daly to get out of this jam. Runner at second base. Tie ball game, bottom of the ninth.
Whitey up on the top step of the dugout. Mets were within one pitch of a victory. Then the Pendleton homer. And now the Mets are within one hit of the win. Daly peering in. Time called. 2-2. Mookie Wilson stands back in. Bill Allman out at second. Another foul. San Diego is still batting in the second inning and leading Houston now 3-0. Texas got three in the first at California. Here we're 4-4, bottom of the ninth inning. Fouled away again. And Daly and Mookie Wilson battle here before this big crowd.
Ken just tried to throw that one past Mookie, but Mookie was up to the task. Just got a piece of it, following it off, and so it's 2-2. Tim Tuffle waiting in the wings.
High 3-2. Minnesota has tied Cleveland. That game is now 10-10 with Cleveland batting in the ninth.
The Twins trying to win the American League West.
Foul tip. Pena almost held on. Mookie Wilson, he homered here in the second after striking out in the first, walked in the fourth, sacrificed in the seventh. They start the chant, "Let's go Mets," and a payoff pitch coming from Daly. And he struck him out. Big, big strikeout by Kenny Daly as he gets Mookie Wilson.
Let's take a look at that again. Ken Daly just bearing down. He just fires it. A bullet at the letters. And watch Ken pump up. Yeah. Yeah. A big strikeout. Mookie Wilson goes down. So there are now two outs. And here's Tim Tuffle.
Tuffle singled and scored in the first. Walked in the second. Grounded out in the fourth. Reached on a fielder's choice in the seventh.
I'd say this is a very important batter right now because on deck is Keith Hernandez.
The winning run, Bill Allman at second base with two out, bottom of the ninth inning. It's 4-4 as the Cardinals came back to get three in the top of this ninth inning. Inside, ball one. Had some year. He's standing in there with a 316 average. Ball two. San Diego is still batting in the second inning against Houston, and they now lead 6-0. Oh, the Padres striking early against the Astros. Hernandez is on deck. There is Hernandez, who has doubled, scored, had an RBI. He's 2-for-4.
Also had a tremendous day, tremendous evening defensively.
Daly got that one down the middle, 3-1.
New York ties Toronto. They're 5-5 in the eighth inning. Toronto batting. It's 4-4 here at Shea. Daly's not went for one outside the strike zone, a high hard one.
Yeah, Daly's not messing around at all. He's just rearing back and firing. 3-2, two outs, bottom of the ninth inning, the winning run. In the person of Bill Allman at second base.
What an exciting evening it's been. Now Tuffel steps back out. Fouled away. Tim Tuffel and Ken Daly battling bottom of the ninth inning. Better than 53,000 watching with you. These National League East rivals going at it here. Mets look like they had it in the bag. Pendleton's homer in the ninth tied it up. We're 4-4 bottom of the ninth inning. The walk to Tuffel. Two on and two out for Hernandez. First walk given up by Daly.
With the Mets having runners on first and second, what you'd like to have is your best left-handed reliever on the mound, and that's who the Cardinals have out there in Ken Daly. So it'll be Daly against Hernandez for this ball game.
And let's pause for station identification on the Cardinals television network.
KSDK, Channel 5 in St. Louis.
With Mike Bush and Mike Shannon, Jay Randolph here in the Big Apple at Shea Stadium. The big series, and this the first of the three game here at Shea Stadium in Queens, and Hernandez standing in there. Allman is the winning run at second, bottom of the ninth, two out. 3-0 playing behind the runner at first. Ground ball, 3-0, and we'll go to extra innings. After nine complete, 4-4-0 for the Cardinals, 4-10-1 for the Mets. In extra innings, the Mets are 5-8 this season. The Cardinals have won 12 and lost 8. Let's show you the blast from the bat of Terry Pendleton that tied this ball game up. Here it is, down the middle. It looked for a moment like Mookie Wilson was going to catch this ball, and he just watched and watched and watched, and there it goes. And just got over the wall out there.
I'll tell you something, Jay, that was not a bad pitch by Roger McDowell. It wasn't up. His sinker ball sank, though not quite as much as he would have liked, and Terry just went out and got it. And boy, did he show some power on that one.
Well, the second inning is still not over at San Diego, and they lead 7-0, and they're still batting.
Alineers Astros struggling a little bit over there in the National League West.
Bill Allman stays in the game. He'll play at shortstop. And Jesse Orozco is on the hill. He's the fourth pitcher of the night for the New York Mets. This is his 49th appearance. Orozco 3-7. Not having a dynamite year, but this fella is very, very tough. And the Mets, Jesse Orozco is 1-0 and unscored upon in his last three outings. So as we have documented time and time again, these Mets have been playing extremely good baseball over the last three, 4 weeks. And they've made a big run, of course, in this National League East race.
And to lead it off for the baseball Cardinals will be Tony Pena, who steps up for the first time tonight. 4-4-0 for the Cardinals, 4-10-1 for the Mets. We're in the top of the 10th inning. Tony Pena leading it off. He'll be followed by Vince Coleman and then Ozzie Smith. First pitch by Orozco. Big swing by Tony. 0-1. Steve Lake started the game at catcher. He was replaced a little later by Tom Pagnozzi, and now Tony Pena, the third catcher of the night for the Cardinals. Any old kind of a run would put the Cardinals in front. It's 4-4. Orozco delivers, and there's a lineout to Bill Allman. Thought for a moment it might have a chance, but it was not hit hard enough, and there's one gone for the Cardinals here in the 10th.
Left fielder, Vince Coleman.
A little soft liner that might have been able to find its way through had it been a little more towards second, but Allman comes over and makes the play. It is now Johnson, Allman, Tuffle, and Hernandez on the infield here.
And Vince Coleman steps up to the plate. 1-for-3 tonight. In fact, when the Cardinals went to the ninth inning, they only had one hit, and that was a bunt single by Vince Coleman. Coleman walked in the first, struck out in the third. As he fouls that one back. Got the bunt single in the sixth, but then was picked off second base. And he grounded into a double play in the eighth inning. A controversial double play because the replay showed that Vince beat the throw to first base. 0-1 to Coleman. Here's the pitch. Fouls it back, and it's 0-2. When you think of Jesse Orozco, you think back to October 1986. He was on the mound when the Mets won the World Championship. A good look at the left-hander. 0-2 to Vince Coleman. Here's the offering. Ground ball. Deep short. That's a base hit. Coleman turns the corner at first, and the Cardinals have a base runner. Not any base runner. They've got Vince Coleman at first base with only one out.
Vince tonight bunted his way on for the first hit for the Cardinals, and the only hit they had until the ninth. He did that in the sixth. Here he gets one deep into the hole. Allman can't get to it. Earlier in that sixth inning, Coleman stole his 98th base of the season and then was picked off. And now let's see how the Redbirds want to play it.
So the situation is this. There's one out in the 10th. Tie ball game. Vince Coleman at first. Here's Ozzie Smith. Orozco, little token toss to first. Coleman there easily. They'll be watching him closely. He's the go-ahead run for the Cardinals.
He could be running. This is a good hit-and-run combo, of course, with Coleman and Smith.
Again, Orozco goes to first. Coleman has one stolen base tonight. He stole it in the sixth, but then, as I mentioned, he was picked off second base. Ron Darling with one of the great moves in the National League. Coleman likes to run against left-handers because he can watch him more carefully than right-handers. 0-1 to Ozzie.
Nick Leyva coaching at third. Coleman over there at first. John McSherry, the umpire there.
The infield at double play depth. Of course, the Cardinals might be trying the old hit and run because one of the Mets is going to have to go over and cover second base, and that opens up a hole in the infield. 0-1 to Ozzie Smith. One out in the 10th. Vince Coleman at first. Orozco comes plateward. Ozzie takes. 1-1. Ozzie hitting at 299. Has 70 RBIs. He grounded into a double play in the first, struck out in the third, walked in the sixth, and walked and scored in the ninth.
Actually lined into that double play off the pitcher.
Right.
It was a very tough break at the time. Coleman had walked, and Ozzie had one go off the glove of Darling and ricochet right to Santana, who at that time was at shortstop. Coleman running on the play was doubled up.
1-2 now to Ozzie. On deck, Tommy Herr. Cardinals have been out hit 10-5, but we're all tied up 4-4. Remember, Jack Clark is not in the lineup tonight. He will miss all three games of this Mets series with a sprained ankle and a sprained wrist. Orozco. Coming playward, Ozzie with a base hit to left. Coleman around second, heading for third. McReynolds up with it, throws it back into the infield, and the Cardinals are in business with runners at first and third and only one out.
Wonderful, wonderful. The Wizard has been something special. Boy, he worked so hard in the offseason, pumped the iron, and got himself in great shape, and what a remarkable year he's had.
Another look at the swing by Ozzie Smith. That was high and hard, and he just lined it in the left, and Coleman never hesitated. Around second, he's at third. There's only one out. A sacrifice fly could put the Cardinals in the lead.
Here's a man who is overdue, overdue, overdue. Tommy Herr.
So far tonight, Herr flied out in the first, grounded out in the fourth, did that again in the sixth, and again in the ninth. So Tommy is wearing the collar so far tonight, looking for his first base hit, and what better time. 4-4, 10th inning, first and third for the Cardinals. The go-ahead run at third base.
And the Mets draw the infield in.
Here's the pitch to Tommy, late with that swing. And it's 0-1.
Think about a lot of things here. Possibility of the squeeze, of course.
Well, you got your fastest runner at third. Might not be a bad idea. Tommy struggling to swing the bat a little bit. A good fundamental ball player. He could lay one down. Tommy swings and a base hit in the right field. Here comes Vince Coleman. He scores. The Cardinals take the lead. Ozzie Smith at third, and the Cardinals lead it 5-4.
How about that? Boy, oh boy, Herr has come through. And what a way to come out of the slump for Tom as he ripped one out into right center. And the Birds lead this game 5-4. Herr stayed back and went with that pitch in good shape. And this one is, of course, far from over, but this has been a comeback of great proportion here tonight.
And Todd Worrell is up in the bullpen, starting to warm up for the Cardinals. Dan Dreesen now the batter. 5-7-0 for the Cardinals, 4-10-1 in the Mets. We are in the 10th inning. 1-0 to Dan Dreesen. Dreesen 0-2 tonight. He's walked a couple of times, scored a run. Tommy Herr, the runner at first. Ozzie Smith at third. Still only one out. Need an insurance run or two. That misses. 2-0. Orozco struggling here.
That was Herr's 72nd RBI of the season, Mike, and put a star by that one.
Yeah. Well, he struggled a little bit, but boy, he's still a run producer. There's a strike. 2-1. Two balls, one strike, one out. Cardinals leading at 5-4 in the 10th. Orozco pitches. Dreesen swings and fouls it back. Evens the count at 2-2. To recap the scoring, the Mets scored 3 in the first, 1 in the second. Cardinals scored 1 in the second, so the Cardinals went to the ninth inning trailing 4-1. But we're in the 10th now, and the Cardinals lead it 5-4. Here's the pitch by Orozco, swinging a ground ball, could be 2. No, they'll only get 1 at second. Dreesen safe at first, another run comes home, and the Cardinals lead it 6-4.
Dreesen picking up his second RBI since joining the club.
Tuffel made a good play going to second, but Allman's throw wasn't going to even get Dan Dreesen, who's not exactly the fastest ball player. Used to have some legs, but not so much anymore. And so the Cardinals now have a two-run lead here in the 10th. And Willie McGee steps up. What a big hit he had in the ninth inning.
He kept it going. He got the RBI, but it didn't mean anything at the time particularly, except that the Cardinals were within two runs and that he was on base and gave the opportunity for the tying run to come to the plate. That was Pendleton. He popped it over the 310 mark in dead center, and we had a whole new ball game.
6-4, the Cardinals on top, two outs, top of the 10th. Orozco to McGee. Fly ball foul off to the right side. Dan Dreesen at first base. So far tonight, for Willie, he walked in the second. Flying out in the fourth. Grounded to a fielder's choice in the seventh and then was picked off first base, and then he singled. What a big single it was in the ninth inning. 1-1 pitch on the way. He swings and he misses, and it's 1-2. Montreal lost today in Chicago, 8-4. So if the Cardinals win here, the Expos are three back. The Mets would be 2.5 back. Here's the pitch. Another foul ball. Willie hanging in there, 1-2.
And how big this win would be, because it would mean no matter what happened from here on out, the Redbirds would still leave New York in the lead.
And you know, they lost three in Montreal. It was so important to come into this game and win at least the first of this three-game series. Willie strikes out, but the damage is done. The Cardinals score two more. The 10th. In just a moment.
It'll be Darryl Strawberry to lead it off as we go into the bottom of the 10th inning here, as the Redbirds have a 6-4 lead. They've been out hit 7. Or they've been out hit 10-7, and the Mets have committed the only error. Strawberry to lead it off, and once again to put the capper on this one, I hope, Mike Bush.
Cardinals lead it 6-4, but they've got some work ahead of them. Darryl Strawberry, Kevin McReynolds, Gary Carter will bat for the Mets here in the 10th. Strawberry, with a notion to bunt, pulls it back. 0-1.
Wouldn't have been a bad idea. Pendleton was way back at third, and the Mets, just like the Cardinals a while ago, need base runners. Need one anyway to be in a situation where they could tie it up.
Ken Daly, who did such a marvelous job in the ninth inning to get out of a jam, now has gone 0-2 to Darryl Strawberry. Strawberry with a big two-run home run in the first. That helped the Mets get out to their lead. There's the pitch. He got him. Attaboy, Kenny. And there's one gone. Ken Daly just bearing down and out-dueled Darryl Strawberry. And here comes Kevin McReynolds.
Here it is again. And Daly gets one low and away. And Hernandez, and Strawberry, I should say, is out of there.
Now he's got to face a couple of right-handers. McReynolds, the first. Foul ball, 0-1. McReynolds singled in the first, flied out in the third, grounded out in the fifth, and flied out again in the eighth. So he's 1-for-4. 0-1 pitch on the way. 0-2.
Milwaukee leads Detroit 5-2. Milwaukee batting in the eighth inning. New York and Toronto tied 5-5. Toronto batting in the ninth. That game up in Toronto.
No balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch. High. 1-2. One ball, two strikes, one out. Kevin McReynolds, the batter. Ken Daly on the mound for the Cardinals. Cardinals leading it 6-4. We're in the 10th inning here at Shea Stadium. Cardinals with a big comeback in the ninth inning tonight. McReynolds hammers one deep to right field, backing up David Green against the wall. He makes the grab. Well, McReynolds sent it a long way to right. But Green stayed with it, and there are two outs. The Cardinals one out away from victory. And Gary Carter is the batter. Carter tonight is 0-for-3. Walked in the first inning. Some of the Shea Stadium crowd headed toward the exits. Daly's first pitch, a little inside, 1-0. They had 53,766 in the house tonight. The largest paid at Shea since the Cardinals and Mets met on September 11th. Fly ball left field. Here comes Coleman, and you gotta love it. The Cardinals win it. The Cardinals with a comeback victory here at Shea Stadium have beaten the New York Mets in the first of three, a crucial three-game series for the Cardinals, 6-4.
A happy bunch of Redbirds, Mike, as the totals are on the board there. 4-10-1 for the Mets, 6-7-0 for the Cardinals. Some come from behind victory. The Cardinals now are 13-8 in extra inning play. The Mets drive to 5-9, and this come from behind victory stops the Cardinals slide and gets them 2.5 games in the lead over the Mets and 3 games in the lead over Montreal, who lost this afternoon. Well, there are a number of heroes in this one tonight. Ken Daly closed the door after the Cardinals got the lead. Tommy Herr got the big RBI to give the Cardinals the lead. But tonight's Meineke Discount Mufflers Most Valuable Player Award goes to Terry Pendleton. Terry was the man of the moment tonight. In the ninth inning, his two-run homer tied this ball game up at 4-4 and allowed the Cardinals to go on and get the victory. The award, a $50 donation to the St. Louis Variety Club, sponsored by Meineke Discount Mufflers, domestic and foreign car specialists. The Redbirds come from oblivion to win this one tonight. They were one pitch away from defeat in the ninth inning when they came up with the 3 runs, highlighted by the 2-run homer by Pendleton, and the final is 6-4. A reminder that tomorrow NBC will have the coverage from here, and then on Sunday afternoon, we will be on the air at 12:30 Central Time with the third game of this series. So the Cardinals are victorious over the Mets. They pull it out. A big win in the Big Apple. And for Mike Bush and for Mike Shannon, Jay Randolph, so long from New York. St. Louis Cardinals baseball is a presentation of KSDK Sports.